top of the mountain. It's a long way, it's a long way. From the top of the mountain to the top of the mountain. With Twitch chat or just Twitch broadcasting?
Twitch information about translation and chat here to enter.
Oh, okay. I mean, the way I have it is like, if I want to give items to like 40 Rebecca, I need to log in. I log in and then I can give them out as I would normally. That's what I wanted to say. Which is annoying, but...
Yeah, but if you log in there once using like, the browser...
Two, three weeks.
Yeah, and it works. So that's it. Yeah, you don't need to do anything else. So one-time gig. What are you looking for? Hey, heatsink. Look at the heatsink.
Everything very serious.
Heatsink.
Look at that focus. He can't hear us. He absolutely muted himself. Now he disconnected. Oh! Well done, heatsink. Pro streamer. That's a pro streamer.
No, to teraz możemy zaczynać.
Oh, let him load again.
He trolls.
Pro streamer is back!
Yeah, I'm always a pro streamer, I tell you.
Alright, let's start then. Evening everyone, howdy, welcome on the Showdown podcast premiere video. Marshall Draku, your host here. Tonight we start with three guests, with three harder hosts. That all of them. Amazing content creators, you can see on the screen, they are co-hosting that podcast. We are still missing TNT. He's laying awake. We're not gonna lie. He's saying, "Oh, this is a lazy, lazy, cheeky, breaky lad," and he's laying awake. We're missing another content creator. We're missing Twitcher US. He's at work. He'll join us later as soon as he come back. But currently, we've got with us Hitsing 77, Bear Trader. And we've got with us Candies. Me, as you are here, probably already know. Yeah, Teta Partner Channel, Marshall Draku, the posse person, absolutely, that's me, one and only, the best in the West. Yeah! What I'm doing? I'm genuinely speaking, doing everything I can to provide the value for the people here. But I'm not the center of the world, and tonight every single person, a part of me, is most important person here, and we're gonna start from some short introducing speeches from all of our members. We start with Hitsing 77. Hitsing, tell us to all the viewers or the listeners, because some of you will be listening us, some of you will be watching us, wherever you will be, on Hyper, on YouTube, or on any podcast software, when you're listening and watching us, hopefully you will be able to imagine yourself, who the hell that lad Hitsing 77 is. Hitsing, tell us a few words about yourself.
Right, so, well, I'm a gamer for life, basically, so I stream different games, mainly sci-fi. I engage with the viewers quite a bit, so I see myself as a bit of a communicator with other people and all that. So I'm the controversy of a gamer, so I'm not a geek at the screen and all that, but I'm also into cryptocurrencies and IT, so I'm quite technical and all that, and so I'm a bit mechanical in my ways of speech, but other than that, I'm the best lad. Probably a second after the posse. That's me.
That's him. That's the guy whose main and favorite stuff to do on the stream is eating the mic. Yeah, everyone knows that. Yeah, he's not eating like a proper food on the stream. He's eating the mic. Yeah, that's the Heatsink diet. Welcome, Heatsink. Another person who's starting with us already is Bear Trader. You probably heard about him. This is a crypto freak from the Theta TV. Bear, can you tell a few words about yourself to our viewers and listeners?
Yeah, hello all. My name is Bear Trader. I'm a crypto trader from 3 years, and I'm in financial about 15 years already. I'm crypto geek, as you have already said, and I'm from Poland. Hello all.
Well, that was quick. All of them creators, I'll mention that because like they seem like do not want to self-promote themselves, but all of them are streaming here on Theta TV. Yeah, this is our home, this is our main platform, and they are all streamers on Theta TV. They are amazing on the creators, and the last but the best we left for the end with us is Candice. Candy is also amazing streamer, amazing creator on Theta TV. Candy, can you introduce yourself to viewers and listeners?
Hello. I'm Candice. I'm from Ukraine. I'm a new streamer on Theta TV, but I'm not new on Theta. And I'm not very good in cryptocurrency, but I try to fix it.
You see how modest these streamers are. No boom, guys. What are your favorite games? Heatsink, what are your favorite games?
Oh,
you said you are a gamer for life. What are your favorite games? You said you are a gamer.
Oh, that's a good question,
you
huh?
Don't tell me you're playing Roblox all the time.
No.
Yeah, and see, don't listen to him. He's playing Roblox all the time. He just sent his brother on a stream to play different games, so that he has some content.
Sure. Well, I play Apex Legends, League of Legends. Yeah, a lot of Legends and all that. Really, FPS, sci-fi, sometimes cyberpunk and all that. But as I said, it has to be about the community. So who cares? I can play anything really, as long as it's not very popular, because I don't play what everybody plays, so.
This is an interesting approach. I'm gonna try to touch it as a separate topic later on, but I'll put it into the notes in a moment. Bear, what are you playing in? You play games, or you only trade on the Binance?
Almost time I'm trade, but my favorite game is Solitaire and Sapper.
Yeah, I think this is a common Windows Windows starter.
Yeah.
These are my favorite games. Yes,
Candy, what are your favorite games? What do you stream? What do you play to enjoy yourself, to chill?
What do you think about this?
No, I've seen you streaming. I've seen you streaming GTA 5 a lot.
Yes,
yeah?
I stream only GTA 5, and this is my favorite game now. I stream GTA 5 online. This is new for me, and I enjoyed it.
But do you play any other games apart of the GTA 5?
I started, my first stream was on the TV. It was Space Rangers.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah. And Dishonored.
Yeah, difficult game. Mm-hmm. Difficult game. Very difficult game.
That was very difficult for me. So I have had this game with a bad end, not without stealth.
You see, I'm playing everything, apart of the Heatsink games. I'm not playing Roblox. I'm not playing on Fortnite.
I don't play Fortnite. Okay.
Oh, but he didn't mention Roblox! Got him! Caught it, handed!
No, I said Fortnite because that's the worst of the games currently. And I don't play Roblox.
Well, I'm not saying the game is bad, it's just the joy, you know. It's not bringing me the joy.
And who's the one saying, it's not a bad game. Who's defending it right now? So you play it, huh? Mm-hmm.
No, I used to play for first two seasons quite a lot in Fortnite, and then I got absolutely burned out, and there's no chance I can come back to that game unless with some friends and shenanigans to play the save the world part of the game where when you play the co-op, yeah, that's something that I can do, yeah. But to play that battle royale, I'm absolutely too much of that everywhere. Everyone is doing the same stuff and it's boring, yeah. Just be honest. Unless you want to be a pro, yeah. Go for that competitive level. It's boring for me, you know what I mean? Like, maybe jump in and play from time to time. But, like, for the longer stuff, nah. I can see Twitcher. Twitcher, are you finally joining us? Twitcher is listening to us, but he's still not joined. So I'm waiting for that cheeky breaky. He's not a cheater, and you know, he's telling us
doesn't
a lot.
Like
of
us. Doesn't like us.
A lot of the you know, like fairy tales. Yeah, you know, I'm so he's always tired. he may be on holiday doing nothing and he will be tired.
Okay.
Always every game books on him, you know what I mean? Nobody's got the problem with the game, Twitch has got the problem with the game all the time. No matter what he's gonna do, he's always got the problem, yeah. Nobody's got the book, Twitch has got the book. Nobody's game crashing, Twitch or games crashing.
Yes!
Absolutely.
Yes!
So true! So true!
So he's mental from Poland.
Cheeky breaky, man.
Yeah.
Cheeky breaky!
Yeah. Speaking of cheeky breaky, Twitcher! Better late than never! Twitcher is here!
Ladies
and gentlemen, Twitcher US! Came back from his work to join us in the premiere show of the Showdown podcast. Twitcher, because you're late, you still got your time now to introduce yourself.
No. First, what did I miss? What you were talking about?
Who the hell are you? You know what I mean? Because you didn't introduce yourself, so I was introducing yourself, and everyone was introducing you. Everyone said that you are that one of a kind lad that his games are breaking and, you know, nothing works for him yet. You are one
of
the
Yeah, I bought Serious M4 today. You will see it will fuck up when I stream it.
Okay, but tell the viewers and our listeners, because people will be watching us later on YouTube Hyper, they will be listening on different softwares. So tell a few words about yourself. What are you doing? How did you get on Teta? What are you streaming? You know, I mean, what's your hobby, stuff like that? Introduce yourself.
I just come back from work and it's not stopping. I'm a streamer from Germany. I speak Russian and, yeah, English. I'm trading a little bit in Binance. Teta, I just bought Teta for $300 today. And I saw the Chainlink collaboration, Teta and Chainlink. Awesome. I don't know what to say anymore. I'm playing games like mostly shooter. I don't like strategy games in 2D. Almost first person and third person. I'm all in with everybody. Did I miss anything?
Ladies and gentlemen, partners, that's Twitcher. Twitcher US, Cheeky Breaky Brenka. That's another amazing content.
I think Heatsink is much richer than me because he got his 10,000 crows. I will never get my 10,000 crows. So Heatsink is deep in.
No, we were just starting. We're talking about the games we're playing. We're just having.
Wait, how long are you streaming already? No? Like this session?
We just started. We're waiting for you and for TNT because TNT is he's a lazy lad. He's still laying awake. He's sleeping, you know what I mean? We knew you would be like in a moment. Yeah, we were talking about you and we wanted, you know, to get you as soon as possible because TNT is asleep, you know. I don't know. This is absolutely disastrous. How long you can sleep, Twitcher?
14 hours. Tell me, guys, how long 14 do you hours easily.
What? Sleep. Yeah. That's your normal sleep time.
I'm like Michael Jackson, you know. In the dreams, I take drugs and then I travel in my dreams far away, you know.
You just have a very good sense of humor.
Maybe.
How long do you sleep, guys? Candy. How long do you sleep usually?
8 and more hours.
Very good, Candy.
8,
4 hours.
Oh.
Hitting.
So you are Twitch US or you are Twitch DE? So you are, because you are from the Germany.
Twitch are us. I don't know. I mixed it. It's like Twitch are US, Twitch are us.
Okay.
Twitch are Rus also.
Twitch are Rus. Like,
yeah, oh. It was mixing at the start, and I just searched a unique name, and yeah, that's what happened. I didn't think long. I just saw like, oh, Google saying nothing. Okay, claim that name, and nobody can take it. That's how I did.
Yeah, but that's one of the best ways to claim yourself a nickname. Yeah, you go and search if there's any social media with that nickname when you're creating the account. Yeah, when you're creating nickname brand, and check if there is not someone else already using that. Yeah, because you know you're gonna get yourself crazy, crazy. Yeah, and then you go on Google and you see that there's like 20 people using the same nickname. And how do you wanna say that this one's yours? Yeah, that's you. You know, so it's like. This is the best idea, yeah? So simply that Twitcher wanted to do Twitcher Rus, but because his keyboard broke, like usually his computer broke, and he lost the R, so it's Twitcher Us. nothing new, yeah? I hopefully TNT will gonna wake up sooner or later and join us. We're gonna try to talk about some important for us communicators, theta streamers subjects that got influence on all of us as viewers, as communicators, as players as well, as crypto enthusiasm. Some of us are, yeah. So first subject I would like to touch is one of the recent news. About a partnership between Theta, that consisted of Theta TV, which is the most important for us, and new platform like Steam that's called Ultra. What that partnership is most probably gonna bring for us from all the PR, chat, and or everything that they're trying to sell to us is that Ultra will be a new decentralized Steam, which will be connected with Theta TV, and when you're gonna be browsing the games on Ultra, like you're browsing the games on Steam, when you browse the games, you can see the streams that are people streaming to Steam. Yeah, they are Steam streamers as well. Yeah? You can see Steams there. Yeah, so that will be Theta TV for Ultra. And they are trying to offer a lot of incentives for both platform connection. Like in example, we will be able as content creators stream a game, and while we're streaming the game and someone will be browsing the Ultra, click on the game, we'll be able to see our channel, and using their Ultra account, it's working seamlessly as accounts on Theta, will be able to join the chat, send us a donation, you know what I mean? And if we will be collaborating as content creators with Ultra, we will have our special referral links, and then viewers from Theta or from Ultra will be able to use our referral links to buy the games on Ultra, and we will be some way compensated for that as content creators. I believe personally that it is absolutely amazing idea with all the NFTs that they are providing, like a special crypto tokens that we will be able to use on them, but from my point of view so far it's a very far future. But I would like to hear all of you what you are thinking about that kind of a partnership. Do you think that it has any real influence on you? Does it have any real influence on you now, or do you think it may influence you somewhere in the future? What's your point on that kind of partnership? Do you think it even means, does it even mean anything for you as a content creator currently on Theta? Twitcher, you came last, okay. you can start first. Yeah.
Okay, I was reading about they had their own token, so Tfue will be included and their own token. What was most interesting, that you can get like items, games, and you can just give it away in the mechanism. That's really important. Like if you got the chance. But most important is the mechanic, you know, mechanism. That you got the mechanism and the result that you can do it how you want to do it. Like, how do I do it? Tell it properly. Yeah, at the same time, it's not out yet, you know. How many times it was before? Yeah, this will be, and it sounded awesome, and at the end, it just was a quick exit scam. But for now, what if it will come true, what they're talking about, I'm looking, it looks really, really good. I like it, like, with that you can, like, trade items, that you can trade games, which you have, that you can decide on your own. And then with the interrogation with Theta and the Anova token of themselves. And also, I hear that they want, like, to bring, like, millions of people to them. I don't know from where they will do it, you know, but sounds interesting.
Yeah, yeah. So this is like you mentioned, it's not out yet. And what kind of impact it's got for you now? Does it have an impact on you now? Like, apart of the hype and the possibility to invest into the token?
Oh, the token is already up. I think it's over 10 cents. I think I'm a little bit late. But
yeah, I think same, because it's on KuCoin, yeah, and I'm not using that, to be honest.
Not a bit late. You're so late.
Yeah, exactly.
You're so late with Theta.
Yeah, but it's the same thing we thought about Theta.
No, we're talking about the Ultras.
Yeah, but we thought same thing we thought about Theta. Theta is 25 cents or 20. Theta is 50 cents or Theta is 68 cents today, and maybe it will be next month. It will be over $1, and it will be normal. So I don't know.
Yeah, Heatsink, what is your take on that kind of partnership?
All right, now it's my turn, right? Right. I mean, I'm not really too fussed about the project, because let's be honest, there's so many things that Theta announces, like the Theta TV team announce, and how much of it we've seen so far? Not much. I mean, I can't even recall a single thing that has really happened from those partnerships, besides the 24/7 crypto streams, NASA streams, and all that, which just makes people angry all the time. Besides that, I haven't really seen anything. I mean, if it does work, then it's great. Of course, yeah, you're gonna have your another project, so you're gonna have like an increased network and all that, so it's more engaged and incentivized, so to say. Viewer base, if it's going to be on Ultra and all that, it'll be also on Theta or something, but it's still not quite clear on how they like see this to be done in that perspective. Even if you...
Pardon me, I interrupt you. Is there anything clear on Theta?
No. Well, look.
Is there anything clear on Theta TV?
I mean, look at the we'll just talk about that later, but if we talk about the last couple, like, sponsorships and all that, right? What was the biggest one? Samsung, right? Samsung were to introduce their newest devices with Theta TV pre-installed by default, right? Where is that? It's been, what, half a year?
I don't know. I don't have new Samsung, so I can't say if it's pre-installed or not.
I mean, my parents bought like a new Samsung device like, what, 2 months ago? Nope. Maybe in Korea, who knows? But not like that, man.
So you want to tell me it's not pre-installed on the Samsung, yeah? I can't check it because I can't buy the phone like that because it's too expensive. But you want to tell me that it's not pre-installed on the new Samsung?
No, I haven't seen it. Unless their plans are for 2025 or something, then maybe.
This is very interesting info. I think we will have to dig it out because I didn't even know about it. All right, Candy, what's your take on a subject like that?
I agree with Twitchers, but this is sounds good in theory, very good news, but how it will be on practice and when we will get these million viewers on Theta TV.
Oh, I like that. This is absolutely amazing.
I think this is interesting for streamers because maybe we can try different games, new games from this platform.
Okay, Bear, what do you think about that?
About Ultra?
On that subject.
Yes, about Ultra.
About the partnership, yes. Theta and Ultra.
Yes.
Okay, from the beginning, we first had a partnership with NASA, then we had Ubisoft, then AMD. Now we've got a Chainlink and also Ultra. What I would think about this, that we will have more streamers on our channel than our watchers, because everyone to take a part in this pool of earnings, but we don't have more people who will watch our streams. So at this moment, I don't see advantage in this partnership. However, we will probably have a FOMO on the Theta price. So someone said on the chat that he dubbed that I said Twitcher is late in buying Theta token. But if I am saying about buying Theta for 3,000 Satoshi, not for 6,000 Satoshi, because I am playing always to Bitcoin, not to $2.
I've noticed that this is thingy that I'm still learning, that people are talking to about buying in Satoshi, not about USD.
Can I add something for a second? I'm just watching.
Yeah, of course.
I'm just watching Ultra, and they have the same 1 billion of the coins. But when I go to the website and I try to sign up yesterday, so all they say they have a roadmap, they have everything, but you can't do anything, right? Until now, right? Nothing.
Yeah,
you can't just register,
exactly,
right?
Nothing, yeah.
Right.
It's not working.
Yeah, and you see how much pumped it is already at 13 cents with the same coins, 1 billion like Theta. Crazy, and they have nothing. I mean, it sounds good.
Yeah, like this is absolutely amazing push from the PR, yeah? Like you just said, there is nothing for us at the moment. If this is going to work, if whatever they're saying is even partially true, if this is going to work, this is going to happen, this will have a massive impact. But now, it's just another PR mambo jumbo, yeah, let's go! Hype, you know what I mean? There's no influence for us apart from the price of the token.
Yes, this is the next hype, like was ICO in 2017. Then we got hype on DeFi, and now we will have next hype on NFT, because this will be the next hype till the end of this year, I suppose.
And yeah, I think the NFT tokens will be the main thingy. But one of the great things about that Ultra, so from what I said, and we mentioned Twitcher, you weren't here. Ultra signed a partnership with Atari. I don't know if you have already seen that.
Yeah, I know Atari.
With their new console, because Atari is releasing like the old school style hybrid of the old computer and the console now, yeah. And they will be fully co-working and implementing the whole Ultra inside. If this is gonna be properly done, that will also influence the Theta TV, because Theta TV will be the streams of the Ultra platform, like Twitch, like Steam's got its own streams. I think if it all will work, it makes sense. But I don't know if anyone noticed, there is no dates. Nobody gave even a closer date. Like, there's no estimated time of arrival, you know what I mean? Not at all. Or I'm blind and I can't find any, you know what I mean? I don't know, maybe anyone seen something like that, something's gonna be released or something about that.
For me, it's the same problem like was in 2018 with Game Credits token. Maybe someone of you reminded this token. Everyone was talking about the hype with a partnership with EA, and nothing else happened with this token. I lost about $10,000 about on this token. Yeah, sometimes it happens.
Yeah, that's why there were a lot of scam gaming coins before. So this time everybody watched like 10 times before he really invest, you know. There are a lot of scam. Since 2017 there were so much gaming coins with announcements and it was crazy.
Twitch us. Don't say that, because when you look about DeFi, about the problem with DeFi, the problem like sushi scam. Sorry, sushi swap. So we've got the same problem with hype. We will see the same problem hype with NFT. And I'm now looking for a roadmap of Ultra, and I am not seeing this on the
page. Yeah, I also checked, like.
Yeah.
My problem is that, you know, I personally am not too much bothered about most of them all projects because they talk BS, PRBS, that doesn't matter much at all, you know what I mean? Until it happens, it's just talking, yeah? Until it happens, it's just talking. There's nothing about that, yeah? So if it's not influencing me at the moment or not influencing me at all, it doesn't matter. But Ultra, with its very, at the moment, aggressive crypto marketing, does, I think, influence us partially, because partnership Ultra Theta and hyping both platforms together makes Theta token and at the same time T-Fuel price rise, yeah? I believe I'm right, yeah? We can see that by now. And when the T-Fuel price goes up, means that all Theta streamers, all Theta content creators goes better as well, because if we hold the T-Fuel, which we in theory supposed to be earning, we're gonna be better with that as well. So I believe that even that platform doesn't work, at least temporary, it's in theory, again in theory, because it's we're supposed to be earning the T-Fuel, in theory it's supporting us as well, yeah? So it's a good thing, yeah? From my point of view, Let them talk more bullshit and let them people believe in that bullshit PR, you know, just that's the win for us.
Can I add something? I think the most important thing is the mechanism. So if the coder of, let's say, Ultra says, I have something, I will do something, look, Twitch us, tomorrow there will be an update and then you can take your Steam items and gift it to your viewers. I programmed it that you can take it from your Steam and directly gift it to them, and it will happen as a mechanism, you know, and this will be one. And then he adds, oh, you can also gift Steam games to them somehow when you have it as a gift. And this mechanisms are the most important. And this is the shit what the coders should talk about, because this is the most important thing in this. If it won't work, or if it will work, everybody will use it. If it won't work, it just nobody will use it. And this is the most important thing, I think.
Okay, this is important thing when it happens, but nobody knows when it happens.
Yeah, but the state already, like before, you can gift games, you can gift your Steam items somehow. I don't know how they will do it. Like, it's like you got your CSGO items that are worth $300, and you can just swap it there. I'm really, really interested how it will look like, you know, and if it will work, there will be a lot of bugs and everything will happen. But for the first time, it sounds awesome. For the first time.
Yeah. Again, it sounds awesome, but it's not there.
Exactly.
It's just on the paper, yeah? There is nothing that we can touch, yeah? But that paper makes a rise of the price of the Ultra token, US. I don't know why it's that kind of shortcut, but it is Ultra tokens US, and it also will partially influence the price, an example of Theta token, which influence price of the T-Fuel, which is in value for us as the content creators here. Yeah,
I suppose today, Candy, today,
pardon, Candy, can you hear me?
Candy, what's up, Candy? We see green screen.
Yeah, I think she can't hear us. All right, Bill, you can continue. I try to catch her in there.
Okay, I suppose the last 2 days raise of Theta price was dedicated to partnership with Chainlink. So mainly, I suppose this is the reason that the price went up, and we see new all-time high on Theta price.
Can I ask you a question, Beer Trader? What I'm interested in. We have 1 billion coins on Theta, and 860 million are in circulating right now. What will happen when the last one of the 1 billion will be sold? I mean, it's not like mining. It's not like mining. It's just somebody owns it, somebody has a wallet, and somebody sells it. What will happen when we have the 1 billion?
Nothing will happen.
Nothing.
No. Yeah, the biggest problem is what will happen if someone will sell more than about 10% of the value of this token.
That's what everybody's scared investing in it. You know, it's 1 billion and it costs 68 cents. I mean, you don't know who is holding exactly how much, and you don't know how much the developers are holding. You know, we had it before.
Yeah, look about situation in the last week with UniSwap and their airdrop about what? How much it was what? I calculated this $1 billion. They gave $1 billion to the people.
Yeah, I got over $1,000 in one day. Yeah, back just because I was using UniSwap.
Yeah. And if you sold it for $8, you had
three. No, I sold it for 2.3 because I was like, I want this $1,000 right now. I will never get a chance like that again in my life. That's why I instantly did.
Many people are doing this.
Anyway,
where is Candy? Anyway, where is Candy?
Candy is fighting with her camera. Let her fight with the camera. We'll get to her back. But you mentioned that you were talking about the chaining and stuff. But chaining is what kind of influence for Theta TV, in example, got the chaining? I'm talking about Theta TV. We're talking here about us streamers, Theta TV, yeah? What kind of impact chaining's got on you? Because I can't see any at the moment, at least at the moment, yeah? Mm-hmm. While at the same time, I don't know if you noticed, lots of the hyped and marketed stuff, you know, PR went on, was a collaboration partnership between Theta and Binance to host PUBG Mobile tournaments with prizes, and which are streamed on Theta TV as an exclusive streams. This is very important, yeah? And I know you've noticed we've had like an additional partner bumped channels that are streaming PUBG Mobile matches on Theta TV live in top spot and front page. When they go live, they are taking like four spots. One spot, two spots are taken by the Anime New channel, another partnership, plus some crypto trader, and like all top spots are there. Yeah, they are taken. What kind of influence for us had that kind of partnership, yeah? Because, okay, we've got that PUBG Mobile. Did you watch it? Did any of you was watching that PUBG Mobile tournament?
I saw it once, but I wasn't interested, and just for a second. I also didn't see that they are like in the middle, like they will be shown like on the main page. I didn't check that also.
How about you guys?
Nah, I didn't check. I wasn't bothered much.
Yeah, this is what I'm talking about, yeah? There's no interest on that, yeah? We know it happened, but everyone, what did they brought to the platform, to the Theta TV? What did Theta TV got from that?
Probably some people would be like, this platform. That's about it, but I guess.
Yeah, but if you watch the viewership on them channels, there's like four channels and altogether the viewership is very... very average, yeah, you know what I mean? So it's like...
So it's good to watch.
Yeah. Okay. Welcome back. Candy is back. Yeah, we can see her.
I'm here again. I'm sorry.
You got her back.
But I can change this round date, so...
who cares? Nobody bothers, to be honest. Nobody bothers. Don't worry about that. So, like I said, this is like, I think, that another thing that's pumping the price of our tokens, because Binance is still a very influential place, yeah, very influential actor. But again, to who Binance caters? Do you think that normal ND Tifa that's playing video games knows what is Binance?
I suppose not.
No. Candy, do you know what's Binance?
No. What is this?
There you go. No. This is absolutely serious, no. Yeah?
Yes.
Candy is our content creator, yeah? She's streaming on Theta, yeah? And she's not interested in Binance. That's what I'm talking about. Majority of content creators here on Theta don't care about stuff like that. Yeah? They don't care. Nobody cares. So if it doesn't cater to us, to whom it caters, yeah? Because it doesn't seem like it brings lots of the influence from outside. I do hope it will bring at least some of the investing kind of a people. And from that, I would like to move to another subject that mentioned before, DeFi, decentralized finance. Because on top of that, Theta also has got their approach about that. And Theta suggests to use amazing smart contracts on our platform to allow decentralizing finance, allow investitions from different people into the streamers on platform. So basically what Theta says, that people who are investors, and that's what we're catering on, and I believe that PUBG and Ultra ads cater to people like that, to crypto investors, yeah, can buy T-Fuel and invest that T-Fuel in the streamers for, in exchange for share of their earnings. This is very important. Anyone who is an investor, yeah, can now buy T-Fuel, then set a deal with the streamer, invest in the streamer, and Theta will add onto streamer's account and investor's account a smart contract, which will, depends on the deal, move some part, some percentage, let's say, like in their examples, 30% of the next year streamer's earnings to the investor. So I personally believe it's absolutely amazing idea. This is something like from another planet, yeah? The season Thetaverse absolutely hits that idea. Can't see anything better. So I was surprised. I had to read that old information many times to understand that someone who found that idea is an again from another level, yeah? Like from another Thetaverse planet. Because idea is perfect. The question is, do you think the same? I believe it's absolutely amazing that someone like Twitcher or Barry,
we should ask Peer Trader.
Yeah, but we are not whales, yeah? Let's be honest, none of us is whales, yeah? But that idea catered to whales, yeah? Am I right? Doesn't sound like that, yeah? Someone is a whale, he's got massive amount of the money that he can spend, so he's getting buying massive amount of T-Fuel and investing into the streamers with the hope that the streamer will grow, increase the earnings, yeah, and get the cut from that earnings, and so he will earn on that. From my point of view, in theory, absolutely amazing idea. But again, none of us is here whales. And how many whales we know? This is additional to that topic. How many whales personally we know? Yeah, to which we could have a chat. And come on, our platform, which is the best platform, I will still replay that. Theta TV, no matter what kind of issues we encounter, because we encounter a massive amount of issues here on Theta, because of the new update, stuff like that, is still the best streaming platform, I believe. And I believe it's got absolutely amazing potential to be that top four. Absolutely. That top four place is for Theta for sure, if they will work hard and realize at least half of what they are planning to do. Because another thing, that investment is idea, plan, yeah, I would like to see it happen, but I also understand there are a lot of the implications of that. But what, like we said, what do you think, Bear, about that?
Maybe first you will answer about what do you think about this about this situation, and at the end I will sum up with my ideas.
From my point of view, okay, amazing idea. I wish to see them whales, them investors coming in, yeah, and signing a deal with the streamers on Teda TV platform.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so everyone. In theory, at now, everyone can come in, buy million T-Fuel, 10 million T-Fuel, whatever the amount of T-Fuel, yeah? And sign a deal with the streamer. And let's say some kind of amount of all the streamers earning, which means subs, donations, T-Fuel pool, and stuff like that, or percent of the Dutch earnings will go to the investor. I believe, from point of theory, it's absolutely amazing idea. It's one of the best ideas I've ever heard, and it could work. It could work if any of us would, as content creators, would already know. From my point of view, it's absolutely my point of view, my opinion. Could work if any of us would knew the whale, who we can talk and show them how it works. If Teta would knew the whales, and Teta would show them how it works, yeah, and introduce it, push it, you know, into them whales. So, because from my point of view, we need that whales, few, not one. One is not doing anything, there's no impact. We need few them whales that will go and do that example, yeah? Okay, we're investing to that steamer, that steamer, that steamer, that steamer, that massive amount of T-Fuel, yeah? And we're gonna see how it goes. And this will build up, this kind of move will instantly, even if they will fail, yeah? Because this is another thing that goes with that. Most of them investments will fail, that's for sure. Yeah, but even if their investment will fail, they are instantly earning because they will push that hype. Yeah, and everyone will want to jump into that hype bandwagon. Yeah, or buy T-Fuel because we can invest T-Fuel in the steamers. Yeah, that's normal in the crypto scene. You just need them few whales that will start the move, and then everyone will go with the wave. And every one of them first investors, even if their steamers will peak, they will lose. Most probably they will lose. There's no point to even lie to yourself. It's absolutely lost case in most of the situations. But if they will buy additional amounts to keep that T-Fuel, even if the investment, the streamers will lose, building the hype for buying T-Fuel, rising the price to the massive amount, they will earn with additional amounts on the T-Fuel that they buy and hold when the wave will come, yeah? That's from my point of view. That's how it works. Because in reality, let's be honest, if the whale is coming here and he can invest, yeah, in the streamer, who that whale is gonna pick? Yeah? Like I said, I don't know any whale personally, yeah? None of you knows any whales personally. So it's not like I can go to the whale and tell him, sir, mate, partner, there's absolutely amazing opportunity on Teda TV. You can invest in me right now, 10 million T-Fuel, and I'm going to share with you 50% of all my earnings for the next year and 30% of all my earnings for year after with the smart contract sorted on Teda TV. I'm a full-time content creator. I've got a 10-year plan for all my content creation. I've got the business plan accepted. I've got a grant from Her Majesty and stuff. I can bring a full information, yeah? Like, I've got a plan, I've got a grant, I know what I'm doing, I know what's my plan for growing the channel, how we can bring more viewership, how we can make the channel earn you more money so you can get back your investment, yeah? But how many streamers here on the platform is full-time streamer like me and can bring that kind of information? How many streamers got experience like me, like on doing the business plans for even for money, yeah? How many streamers like me got a diploma from the finance and plan the finance and do them business plans for them in 10 years, yeah? How many? Do you have a 10-year plan of your streaming, of your growing of your channel?
Not even for 2 months.
No. Bear, do you have a 5 or 2-year plan of growing your channel?
3 years.
3-year plans, not because he's an investor, he's doing in the finance in for many years now, yeah? So he knows what he's doing. Candy, do you have a plan for next years? How are you gonna grow your channel?
This is new for me, and I try as just fun, but now I start to think about the plan, yes, but not completed.
Yeah, but you don't have any plans like, okay, next year I'm gonna do that, and I would like to have that kind of a comeback from that. You don't have the plans like that. You're not doing the business plan for streaming.
Andy,
Эдди, он тебя просто спрашивает, вот за другие два года ты себе уже планы есть, что ты себе представляла, вот это, ты уже продумал эти два года или нет? Именно это он спрашивал.
Two years, no, so far, but I think about social net, about promotion, about this is only start. This is only start for me, and this is new for me, very new for me. I never stream. I have never streamed again. I start stream on July on Teta and on May on Twitch when I was waiting the stream key on Teta TV. This is very new for me, and this is for me it only first time. Was as fun as not a way for earring.
Yeah, you're not planning on as an earring, you just keep it like as a hobby, as a fun, you know, as a diamond, yeah?
Yes. This is a hobby.
Hitting. Yeah. But for me, it's a hobby that I love. This is something that I love. I absolutely love what I'm doing. I'm missing streaming, yeah, when I'm not doing that, yeah? Every day, when I can't stream because I'm busy doing another type of the job, I'm absolutely crazy. I'm, like, addicted to that, yeah? So I would like to provide the value. But I do know how much I'm losing when I'm live here and I'm not doing something else, yeah? I don't understand that. So I've got, like, a lot of the stuff planned for years ahead according to my budget, yeah? But like I said, I'm doing that full time. Yeah, you are working. Plus, when you got some time in the evening, you're jumping into the stream. Yeah? And most of people doing that. Yeah, Hitsing, how many years plan you got of growing up of your channel?
That would be a good question. I mean, to be honest, I don't have like a specific plan, like time frame from the plans that I have. I'm still working on that, but there's. I've got a couple of the main things that I have to focus on, so it's just a matter of really breaking down that into the bigger plan. So to say, so I've been streaming really since almost, yeah, I would say around this time I started streaming last year, so I have a full year of streaming. So one thing that I'm focusing on is really learning skills. Growing myself, so that is the main one of the main things that I'm going for is like one of them includes planning itself, the other one includes social media presence and marketing. Besides that, I'm focusing right now, and my goal is to grow my social media within the next couple of years. Well, my plan is to grow within a certain amount within the next 3 years. I'm not going to provide any specific details right now, just because it's still under construction and all that. But otherwise, I would say if you don't have a plan, it's really hard to go forward, because the last year, within this 1 year, I can tell you that for sure. I've been trying to grind. I mean, I've been grinding to affiliate and all that, so I would say if you really want to like expand yourself, you have to have a plan for that. And if you really want to take it serious, you have to have some sort of a plan that you can relate to and have like someone, what's the word, accountable for. So you have to keep yourself accountable for anything you do. So I don't think that I personally would be able to call that just yet a plan. But as you said, Marshall, there's not also that many people in here, because I mean, the platform itself is very, very immature, I would say. content-wise and viewer-wise, we are quite immature, which is a good time to start. It's a good time to start for us to do that.
Exactly. It's a perfect time. There is no better platform than Theta TV to be discovered. This is a great point, yeah? This is a great point. And now, if any of content creators plan, yeah, they are loving what they're doing, they see what they're doing, they're going, and they plan the future, I believe they are a perfect spot for them whales to be picked up and to be invested in, yeah? Like, I am saying like now, yeah, go on, mate, go buy them 10 millions of TFUE, invest in me, and I'm providing you 2 years plan straight on what will happen to next 2 years to make your investment back with the person, yeah? So what we can do? I also know we have to work together. Like most of the people even don't realize that them full-time streamers like me and a couple others here, we all are self-employed. We are running companies on ourselves and we are paying the taxes from every single penny we're getting from that. People don't realize that, yeah? People don't know that if you are doing that full-time, even if this is not a huge income, it's small income, you still got a show of that income, yeah? You know what I mean? It's like, I'm getting incomes from some many different stuff I'm doing, plus I'm getting income from Theta. And while I could get away from the different stuff with different contracts, I can't get away from the income from Theta, so I still have to run that company, yeah? Still have to be self-employed for tax purposes, yeah? And people do not realize that, yeah? So when you get to that point, when you got a struggle with that, there's also different approach. But like, how many streamers, how many of you are paying taxes from your income from Theta? I believe none of you.
Yeah, nobody's earning to pay taxes.
Well,
I don't earning Theta here. I'm just holding it, so I am not paying taxes because I'm not changing it to fiat.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, from where are you?
You also understand what
where is Beatrader from?
From Poland.
From Poland. Thank you.
Yeah, he's got similar law as we in UK, yeah? Until you got it fiat on your account, you're not paying tax from that, yeah?
I don't like talking about taxes, man.
Let's not touch politics, yeah? But yeah, but that's the thing. So, okay. Do you think if we don't know the whales, if Theta not pushing the whales to invest, do you think there's any reality that this absolutely amazing idea is going to happen?
If I would recommend this product to my customers, I would not recommend this. So I don't believe that many whales will invest in this type of product. This is not a new product because already in 2018 we had a personal coin. It was a boom for personal coins. In Poland we had many people who were creating their personal coins. And I know only one person who is put in PR who obtained success. He had a successful.
Succeed.
And it was Rahim Black, and no one else in which personal coin you invested, you never had a positive ROI. So I don't believe that there is a chance that whales will invest in this type of product. However, I believe it's a good.
But don't you think it's a contradiction? You wouldn't sell that product to your customers. Why?
Because
if you believe it's a good thing, why wouldn't you sell to your customers? Yeah, this is a simple. This is simple
okay,
this
is because it's
question, yeah? Because that was a contradiction. Yeah?
It's,
I believe that's a good,
yes.
But I'm not gonna recommend it.
Yes, because I am because it's too risky. As like you said, it's not too many streamers where we can invest. So it's risky for me.
Yeah, perfect. I agree with that. It's super.
And he will be held accountable. If it goes to shit, he will be held accountable because he gave it to his customers. Don't forget about that.
Yeah, of course. But whole crypto is like a gambling place. You know what I mean? Because majority of the tokens are used for nothing else apart of the gamble. Yeah. Now you can gamble with a proper investment, with a, something that works. You know that. You know what I mean?
Most of my customers invest in Bitcoin, not in altcoins, or because they are. Oni są przyzwyczajeni do tego, że zarabiali 5-10%. I jak są niezadowoleni, są z 20%, ale nie zaryzykują tego, jak w na przykład na jakieś tam 100-200%, oni się nie będą się zadowalać tym.
Yeah, but okay. So Bear Trader said that most of his customers invest in Bitcoin and they are happy with the rate of interest of 5-10% from their investment, yeah? But even if, let's say, would offer them 100% of the rate of interest, it's too risky and they would not go into it. So the thing is that there is, I'll be honest absolutely with you, because I got the numbers, yeah? Nobody has got numbers, and when you touch the subject of numbers here on Theta, people became very salty, yeah? They are all like so greedy that they are so holding numbers, and their numbers got no value because they do not database them, they do not collect them, they do not sort them, they do not, you know, analyze them. I do that, and I've got numbers. There's no chance without a huge investment, and huge, I'm talking huge. Yeah, like in example, if you want to invest in me, you need to invest at least 10 million TFUL at the moment, yeah, for 2 years. And I cannot guarantee you big rate of interest on that. There's no chance. There's no talking about 100%. We're talking with a proper plan, with a bit of luck, 10% of all my from all. If you're gonna take 50% of my earning for a year and 30% for next year, all together, maybe we will push everything how I planned, and 50% of that will work. You will get maybe 5% on your interest. Maybe. The only thing is that if you're gonna do that and we're gonna pump it, because we're gonna use massive amount of that in your investment into the PR, into the advertisement, to the promotion, we're gonna pump it, there's a massive chance that another 10 millions you bought when you were buying 20, 10 you invest in me, 10 you hold, that 10 will grow in the price so much, because we're gonna pump that project, we're gonna hype it, we're gonna spread the info, you know, we're gonna spend the money on advertisement. People will rise that, will go after you, and you're gonna earn all the stuff on your hold token. There's no chance, from my point of view, absolutely no chance, no matter how much you're gonna invest in the steamer, that you're gonna get your token back.
Can I add something? Okay, that were the positive things about it. Okay, let's talk about smart contract. Should be a smart contract, right? Let's say it will come out like you're talking, and it will be out, and everything will be awesome. But what? Let's say somebody invests in you a lot, but it need to be verified with third party involvement. So you are like partner, but we need to verify this, and this will take 1 month. You know, everybody had asked this before. So if it's a smart contract, it should be a smart contract. It should be from you and the investor. The second thing is when it comes out will be the abused mechanism. Let's say that you can like. You can cheat something, and everybody who gets this and he can earn money with this, he will use this for sure. The last thing what I wanted to say, let's say he invests 30% in you, right? And then let's say he invests today in you 30%, and in one year, you don't have 5,000, 6,000 followers. Let's say in 1 year, you have 1 million followers. So he will take 30% from your 1 million followers, and when you would without him make a lot of more money. You should like wait it, and until it's not out, you can't wait it, you know, like the wait, what's right,
no,
what's wrong.
So this I think this goes with the experience, yeah? And it's like, if this is a huge if, that investor will invest in me and we're gonna get, like you said, in 1 year to the million follower, I'm gonna absolutely assure you, without that investment, there's no fucking chance to do that. Pardon my French, but there's no chance. Yeah? So I'm not gonna earn anything.
How do you know?
I'm sure, because the platform is too small and platform is not forcing itself out.
But what if it's the same? Nobody believe Bitcoin will go to 20,000 and just interest it in some weeks. You know,
it's not the same. We cannot compare it's those. Different.
It's different.
Yeah, I know. It's just a topic. If
you're gonna push, let's say, $1 million into the current TV advertisement, you're gonna push the advertisement in the ads on YouTube, on Twitter, on Instagram. You're gonna spam them ads on TV. The viewer base will grow up, yeah. But they are not gonna do that. They don't want to do that, yeah. They want. They hope to grow organically, and I'm gonna touch that in a moment. They want to hope organically, and that kind of growth here, if anyone noticed, that do not work. I don't know. How many more viewers you got, Steamer? Twitcher, how many more viewers you got in last
If I can tell something, I think you noticed Chico Crypto. And as he was streaming, like Binance is also a Theta, and as Chico Crypto was streaming, I said like, oh, again, scammer at Theta, blah, blah, it's not Chico Crypto. And at the end, it was the real Chico Crypto. And I was like, what the fuck? And he even mentioned me in the stream. You know, I know him from YouTube for 2 years, and I don't know how many followers, thousands of followers, yes. And as he was streaming on Theta, everybody came from YouTube to Theta, and they created like 300, 400 accounts in 1 hour, you know. And that was a big growth. A lot of streamers at the end of his stream, they were changing like to another channels. And it in these days where he was streaming, it was a big growth. Like, we need something like that, you know. But we have like Binance or someone, Bybit or something. It's not the official channel, you know. It's somebody who's just taking the name and... streaming 24/7, you know, but I was like, oh, Chico Crypto, you're using his name, fucker, blah blah blah, and then it's just the real Chico Crypto, you know.
Yes.
Yeah, but the thing is, like I mentioned, how much your viewership grew in last 2 months?
10 times better than on Twitch. I can say that.
No. Boom. And this is another. I just said it before. There's no better platform than Theta TV to get discovered. And this is absolutely about that. There's no better community than we got on Theta TV. That's another thing. There's no questions about that. None other platform can compare themselves to us. We've got absolutely amazing stuff that we could use, but we do not have a proper advertisement. And like I said, without a proper advertisement, proper pushed marketing, there's no proper growth. And this is not gonna happen. Unless you are gonna do that yourself, yeah. Unless you're gonna invest or find someone who invests in you to spend the money on the growth, you're not gonna grow. Partners here hit the threshold, yeah, on the platform. There's some threshold you're hitting. That's it. You're not growing anymore. You're done. There's no more viewers, yeah. The only fresh viewers are when we are streaming to all different platforms and we are trying to convince people to come in Theta. The only new viewers are that are find us because of the GFuel, but they usually come here for GFuel, not for watching the streams. This is very important, yeah? Those viewers that are coming here for GFuel in majority, yeah? They are not coming here for watching streams. They're coming here for freebies, yeah? They carry on the freebies. They're jumping from channel to channel and asking for the freebies, yeah? And when they got what they want, they either stay and as long as they need it, or just okay, I've got what I got, see ya, ne? And they forget about the platform. They're empty. The amount of the accounts that stay active is very, very small percent. And this is like a business thingy everywhere. Yeah, that kind of marketing is the marketing that doesn't work for the content we're doing, because none of us is doing the giveaway content. None of us is not leading the channel where our main idea is to give away the stuff all the time for the stream, yeah? We're playing, we're chatting, you know, we're having fun, that's what we're doing, yeah? We're not sitting there, alright, this time we're gonna roll that, we're gonna spin that circle and maybe we're gonna win, who's gonna win? We're not doing that, yeah? None of us is doing that, yeah? This is not our content. Yeah, we would have to sit here like in them old. Some of you probably remember back in time in TV. Who's watching TV now? But back in time when we were watching TV, there were some of the channels and programs when they were doing the shit like that.
oh, you can call me right now and maybe you will have time. Oh, yes, you're gonna win. No, you lost it. So, and the next one, and all the show was about maybe you're gonna win or maybe you're not gonna win. Oh, you finally win. 100 people called, 100 people pay $100 for the phone, one people won 1,000. Yeah, that's what they were
doing. Yeah, one guy who won 1,000 is my best friend. With his new nickname.
Yeah, and nobody's doing content here like that, so it's not keeping them viewers. While the streamers here that are going and getting sponsored by Teta with the supply drops, they got that fake feeling that they are growing because people come in and ask for stuff, for crates, for T-Fuel, for G-Fuel, you know what I mean? And as long as you're giving them viewers, you are growing. But your supply drop is limited. I believe most of people don't realize that the partner supply drop is worse than affiliate at the moment.
Right. I think Marshall, that's a good would be a good thing to do is ask Candy S for that because she's the freshest one. So I think asking her for some feedback right now would be kind of.
I also don't know anything about it. I would be interested about the drops because I'm just a normal streamer on Teta.
Right. So Candy S, could you give some opinion on what we were talking about just now?
Are you serious?
No, I've not at the moment ago that she had come with it new work, yeah. That's why I've let her fix that. See, this is very important. You should know that she's got a timer on the cam. And when the timer stops, that means that the cam stopped, yeah? Something is wrong.
Mm-hmm. Well, anyways, we can have a laugh about that, like the timing or all. But
yeah,
anyway,
but you also have affiliate, right? Or are you partner already?
No, I'm affiliate. Affiliate supply drops are alright, but I would say they're in between. They have kind of buffed it in the sense that you have now like a tab, but at the same time, it's a nerf. If you know the term meaning and all that, so because we used to have like 4 plushies, a couple star kits, and all that, and some T fuel, that's a lot of crates as well. But now it's just really being mainly the G fuel, a couple crates, and coin buffs, emotes. Really, who cares about? Okay, emotes once. Okay, that's fine. Badge, cap buffs. Really. Cap,
but... Yeah, but it's still something. It's still something.
I can give you 500 coins. Just ask me.
What? But this is another thing. That's sharing the culture. Ask me and I'll give you something. And then people are going and asking for more and more and more, giving that fake feeling for the streamers that they are growing. And when they hit the moment that you just hit, that you've got more viewers than you can give him something valuable, yeah? The viewers are leaving and you're staying with a very small amount because you can't share it, that stuff, because and everyone thinks that if they hit the partner they will got that items. And when you hit the partner that piece, I've got less crates than you, mate. I've got less everything than you, mate, you know what I mean? The only thing I've got more than you is two more plushies, yeah? That's it. But I've got everything else less, you know what I mean? Altogether, everything less. And I've got more viewers, more followers, but much more system to give out, you know what I mean? There's no like I cannot catch with bigger amounts of even small items because even small items I got less than affiliate, you know what I mean? So this is not like gonna work. But this is another thing. If you're gonna invest in the streamer who is like growing right now, yeah, your T-Fuel, you're gonna invest to have his share back, yeah. When this streamer is building themselves on the supply drop and he hit that threshold when he can't get any more viewers because the supply drop is not enough. What's gonna happen then? There's no more growth.
Nah.
That's not the plan. There's no more growth because you growth yourself on the, you build yourself on that item. There's no more growth from that. Candy, what do you think about investing into the streamers? That someone is gonna invest T-Fuel in you, let's say some amount of the T-Fuel, and in exchange for that, you're gonna give him for a year 30% of your earnings.
I'm very sorry, I have problem with my cam and I need to restart sometime Discord. Very sorry, I don't know what to do with this. And about your question, tell me please, as you investor, what you experience, ожидания?
Oh, wait.
Wait.
What do you expect as a investor? What do you expect?
Expect that from streamer. How streamer? I can be interested to investor in now in the with Slovak. What do you mean?
She means like when an investor investing today in you, let's say he invests like $1,000. What does he expect tomorrow from you? You know what exactly?
No, tomorrow, Candy.
Yeah, but what's the first point? What's the first point? Like you make a dance for him. Like what if he comes in and says, I invested in you now? No, you have to content. Dance for me here right
invest,
now.
No. It's not about that. It's about that the Theta has got the smart contracts. It's thing that happens in backgrounds. Yeah. So investor can came in on the Theta, invest if you in you, which means give you a money. Yeah. So you can use that money to grow better your channel, but 30% on everything you're gonna earn on your channel goes to the investor.
Yeah, so but what if not? So, what if not? And she invests no, and always, will get mad smart, and she's in the chat.
No. Smart contract. You're gonna get smart contract on your account, and that smart contract is gonna make that every time someone is gonna send you 100 TPU donation, you will only get 70 and 30 will go directly to that investor. Every time someone is gonna subscribe to your channel, you're gonna get only
How much do I have? Okay, Marshall, wait. I have an idea. I want to invest and I want to invest that money in you that I get 30% always from you. How do I do that? I want to be an early investor.
You can't, because you can't afford that.
Why? 30% Come on.
Because no, how no. I said the, no, because this is the important. I know how much I earn.
€1,000, come on.
Okay, no, Tuche, I know how much. Listen to me. I know how much I earn, and I know how much someone would have to invest in me so I can grow the channel to the level that person could get that money. Yeah. In any other case. Like in my case, in like a partner that's got the top viewership and the hours and the plan, you need to invest minimum 10 million TFU in me for 2 years so you can get your money back and earn on it. If you invest less, we're not gonna make it. This is impossible.
Wait, how much? $10 million. This is like
10 million.
Very, very
much. It's
100,000.
10 Bitcoin. No, 10 Bitcoin.
My
so 100,000.
100,000, yeah. If you invest less, there's no chance
then
we can grow.
Okay, that's a very good idea.
Yeah, if you invest less than me, you're never going to get that money back. It's impossible. We're not going to make it. It's impossible. We're not going to make it. It's, you will just lose it, yeah? You will get some back.
But how do you know about the minimum T-field? How do you know? Where does it say that?
Because I know how I'm meaning. Because I know how I'm
meaning.
Yeah, but
what if the smart contract says something else, you know?
No, you don't understand. If, let's say, to do a simple math. If I'm earning, on average, every month, 20,000 TFU. On average, every month. This is the number from Cosmos, from Space Now, yeah? 20,000 every month, yeah? You're gonna get 30% of that. 30% of 20,000 is 6,000 TFU. Yeah, so 12 months in a year,
$60,
12 months,
right.
Go for the 4,000 TFU, 12 months in a year, each month you're getting 6,000 from my earnings, that's my all earnings, soups, my TFU pool, my donations, you know what I mean, all my earnings, yeah, so you're getting 30%, that's 6,000 a month, so at current level, at current moment, so you're getting 6,000 a month, 12 months a year, that's 72,000, 2 years, that 144,000 TFU. 144,000 TFU from me in 2 years now. Yeah, that's 30%. But to get it more, yeah, to get back your money, you need to invest much more. Because if you invest shit money in me, there's no any point for me to get it because I'm not gonna do anything.
Wait, if I invest shit money in you and you grow expansion.
I know, no. If you want to invest shit money in me, I'm not gonna accept you. Because there's no point. I'm not gonna do anything. There's no business.
Yeah, but that's the power of the smart contract. Usually, if the smart contract say so, it's like
yeah,
it's
but,
you ever
like,
say yes or no. You know, both sides of the smart contract.
Yeah, and
that's how smart contract
both
works.
Sides. Exactly, but simple as that. If you're gonna offer me less than 10 million TFU, there's no chat with
yeah,
me.
Yeah, but who says that? You or Theta or who says that?
No. It's between investors. Between investor and you. Twitch streamer and investor set up the deal. And they come with the deal to Theta, and Theta says smart contract. That's it.
Okay, but
and
but what
because that makes sure that investor will get what you
okay,
set
let's ask Beatrice about it. Come on.
And what about what about the crowdfunding? Because if I will, you are talking about that you need 10 million T-Fuel to invest in you. And what about if I will get you about 100 people? Who each of them will invest 100,000 of T-Fuel, and we will also have 10 million. So what about this situation?
And it will work. Same situation.
Yes.
You will get the smart contract for each of them person, yeah.
So
You will, because the Theta offered that. They can do the DAO, yeah, decentralized app, yeah, that will operate this way. That they will add smart contract on my account, and it will still take the amount, the percentage that we set from my account, and then share between your crowd funders, yeah? Or we will share to your pool and you will further on share that, whatever it will be set between your and crowd funders. But you can set, if like I said, you got 100 people, yeah? So everyone will get the even number, let's say, so they can make the smart contract that will share that 30% on the 100 people every month. That's what Theta can do. That's absolutely amazing, yeah? So this will work, but again, you need that amount of T-Fuel to invest in me, so we can grow, so you can earn on me. Because in other case, if you give me less, you're not gonna earn on me.
Yes, I know.
You're gonna lose it.
If I will find
100... So what's the point? I will look...
Yes.
I will get the bad name, you know what I mean? That's gonna kill my brand. It's gonna kill my name. Because you're gonna invest money and say, oh, Marshall, shit! I've invested in him and he fucked up, yeah?
What about money
I know
back?
That if you invest less...
I think just...
Yeah, but
I'm
that would happen,
this,
yeah, exactly.
I'm saying this each month, yes, I'm saying this each month.
Yeah, just let the man speak. Just let the man speak right now. Yeah.
Yeah, but that's not true. Everyone will say, oh, I invested in Marshall and he failed. That was a bad investment and they will kill my brand completely. The price that comes with the bad investment for the streamer, for the brand, is too high to take a risk to invest the small money. Now, imagine if someone will come, like I said, Heatsink. I said to Heatsink, I'm going to invest in you 10,000 T-Fuel for 30% of your current earning now, yeah? And Heatsink said, no fucking chance. Why? Why? Because he knows that I'm never going to get that T-Fuel back. There's no chance. Because that 10,000 T-Fuel is not going to help him grow to the level that I could get it back. He knows that, yeah? He understands that, and he knows what kind of repercussions after that. Because I'm gonna invest in money in him. He knows that he's not gonna happen, so he's not gonna agree because he's fair.
Okay,
yeah?
can I ask
you a question? If he will agree, I'm losing that.
If he would take this 10,000 T-Fuel, what he will do with this 10,000 T-Fuel, like?
Well,
that's his
thing. I mean,
that's his thing. So
yeah,
okay.
that's to me.
So if he will do nothing by no new webcam or whatever or green screen and he would just spend it let's say on cigarettes and everything else and if he will still be bad, it's nothing wrong with that.
That's how you said that. If that's the deal, I agree with him, yes. But if I would be investing in him, I would be asking but I would like to know at least what's your plan, how do you spend it. I would like that's that thing I'm putting with him, you know what I mean? This is the normal thing. This is the normal business deal. This is investments. This is like this is a sponsorship by crowdfunding, by private sponsorship. That's private investment, yeah? This is sponsorship. It's not G Fuel that coming to you and saying you, all right, from now you're gonna get the code, you're pushing our G Fuel, you put the G Fuel brand on the stream, and we're gonna give you 30% of everything you're gonna sell from G Fuel, yeah? Oh, and on top of that, we're gonna throw you $100 a month, yeah? That's investor, yeah? That's your sponsored investor. And that's a different case. So private person coming in and saying you, I'm giving you that, and I want that, what can you offer me? Because this is a simple thing. He's asking, what do you offer me? A part of the money, how do you plan it? So like I said, I'm gonna go to investor and say him, I've got a 10-year long plan, and for 2 years that you're gonna get money from me, my plan looks like that. From that 10 million, this will go for the cams, this will go for the giskins there, this will go for the ads, this will go for the growth of the YouTube, this will go on the growth of the Hyper, this will go on the growth on the... I've got the plan. You know what I mean? Nobody has got it. If you come to me with 10 millions, I will tell you what I'm going to do with that. Step by step. And how
from my point of view, from the analytical point of view, how I can see how much you can get from that bag. I will bring the dynamics to you. Nobody else can do that here. Do you understand me? But if you come to me and say me, I would like to invest in you 1,000. What can you give me back? I will tell you, sorry, mate, but from 1,000, I can't get you anything.
You could say, you could say I can't fart in the microphone on the next stream for you.
You beat the So that's from the business point of view. This is not an investition. You want to give me like 1,000. You can donate it to me and I will dance for you. Yeah, simple as that. But that's not gonna. This is not the business deal. This is not a sponsorship. This is not a investition. This is not a business deal. Yeah, you can. Like I said, you can now Twitcher. How much do I need to invest in you, Tfuel? But now seriously, yeah. Like jokes aside, yeah. How much you want me to invest in you, Tfuel? Yeah, for next year, 30% of your income. How much?
I don't know. Because I have work income. You know, it won't change much if you donate 10,000 to me. It won't change nothing. Not one thing. I'm not gonna pay out it. Maybe I'm gonna even donate it to someone else. You know, so it would be nothing. I think it's to really change everything. It should be a life-changing investment, like you say.
That's exactly what I said. There's no point in investing small amount of money.
You know that I can go tomorrow to my boss, open the door, shit on the red carpet, and say good morning, and go out. You know that investment that I know for the next months, I don't need to go there again. That would be the life-changing investment.
Exactly, and that's what I'm talking about. This is the same thing. I would have to adjust that amount of the TFU immediately, massive, you know. But there's a difference between my earnings and your earnings. Yeah. So I've got like some separated earnings that currently, and I've got the base of the earnings and history of the earnings. Yeah, which you not. Yeah, am I right?
Yeah, I don't have a payout on TFU yet, so...
Exactly. That's what I'm talking about. So now that investor have to count that when he's investing in you, that you still got to grow to the moment of the affiliate, then you have to go to that partner, and he need to think if you are able to grow as fast to bring that TFU back so he can earn the money on you, yeah? So this is very important. Like I said, he also need to invest in you massive amount of money. It's not like he can come to you with 10,000 TFU or 100,000 TFU and you will be fucking jumping for him. No, because not gonna work. We're talking investment streamers. If you want that investment bank that way, while the smart contract is absolutely amazing and it's gonna do the trick, that investment must be massive. Like Candy, this is a perfect person. Candice, tell us, how much do I need to invest in you? How much do I need to pay you TFU? So I can have 30% of all your earnings on Theta back.
I don't know, because this is difficult for me. I have questions too. I'm new in streaming, and might be my question stupid, but it's interesting term for me. And is Twitter, help me please. Существует ли практика на других платформах инвестирования в стримеров? И если уже прописаны...
She's saying, is there another practice on another platforms that are doing the same what Theta is doing today already?
No. So peer
traders say something else. They are, right?
I think Bertrader was saying something about the personal tokens more.
No, that's no. He was talking about like something more like a POSI 69, no. Yeah, like our project,
cause,
like personal project. Yeah,
because I imagine a streamer make content, and have more viewers. I get donation, but the main will get contract for ads, and this is way for earn. I never listen about investor in streamer.
Yeah, but the thing is, like, we're talking about that Theta offers the option, yeah, for
investors. This is special Theta, yes? This is special Theta. This is what make Theta different from other platforms.
Yeah, there's no such thing on the other platform.
Yes.
No other platform allows for decentralized investment from people into the streamers. This is the only thing that Theta offers.
So I
It didn't happen yet. This is what we're doing. Like I said, this is the vision. But in reality, it didn't happen. And in reality, like we're talking, it pretty much not gonna happen. And now we are showing why. Yeah, like I'm asking how much I would have to give you T-Fuel, so you can sign the contract with me, and I'm gonna take 30% of all your earnings.
I think you should ask in dollar that she can understand better.
Okay, so how much money I need to give you? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Invest. Mm-hmm. That's what's called. How much money I need to give you, so you sign contract with me, like I'm an investor, and I'm gonna take for a year 30% of your all earnings from your channel.
On Theta.
30% of your on Theta from your subs, 30% of your donations, 30% of your pool for a year. How much do you want from me?
Я не готова ответить на этот вопрос, потому что I stream only 3 months, and I need to see dynamic of my grow to ask this question. Maybe during the 1 year, after 1 year, I can to answer these questions. Not now.
Yeah, she's saying like the dynamic. Also, the question what I was questioning: what if it goes really good and you invest 30%, and I get, let's say, 50,000, and without you I would earn like, let's say, $1,000, but with you you taking 30% away, and I got 300 only, and you invested not enough, you know. And that's what she's saying. She said after 1 year she can say like the dynamic, when she sees how much she earned, then she would say like yes or no. But now it's early.
She needs to see a dynamic. I already know that I can invest in her. Just the question is how much I have to work her out to get the investment here, because I know I'm gonna get my money back. Do you understand me? Yeah? I already seen her dynamic, yeah, her growth, and I know how much I can expect, yeah? Simple as that. I also know how much I can expect, and I could invest in you, and I could invest in her. I could, on that platform, I could invest in you, and I know how much roughly I would have to invest in you. I don't know how much I would need to invest in her, but I would invest in her absolutely. With my eyes closed, I'm sure I would get my money back. I would invest in TNT. I would get my money back, and I think I could invest in some. And I believe there's a huge chance I could get my money back. I would not invest in anyone else on the platform. I would never ever get my money back. Yeah, simple as that.
It's rude, man. That's rude. We have a lot of
rude, but it's true. But ask, no, come on. Let's go for Bear. How much do you want me to invest in you so I can get 30%? So I can get 30% of your earnings. You know how much you earn. You know how much you earn, yeah?
It's a waste of your.
Remember, I want to earn back.
But
more
let's say
than
it
invest,
in dollar,
yeah?
Please, that we can keep it simply, you know?
Yeah, in dollar.
It's
a
waste of your time investing in me. But if you want to invest in me, it's $1 million.
You hear? But he knows there is no chance that sum must be massive so he can make that money for me back. He knows that. You know what I mean? There's no chance for the small amount of money. He understands that. That's what I say. It's a waste of time. And the only way for me to invest in him so he can push this out is like $1 million. That's massive, yeah? I'm talking for investing in me for 2 years, minimum $100,000. If you go less, there's no chance we even chat. There's no talk about it. Because you're gonna kill my name absolutely. I will be finished. I won't be able to get your money back. I won't be able to make you win. And you will crash my name.
I have
everyone
a question.
Will be talking, oh, I'm just imagining he was bad. He failed.
I have a question. Wait, let's say there are 4 guys investing in me, right? First one is investing 30%.
I don't know, guys, but look, when you are listening, watch on the top right corner what's happening.
Top right corner?
Yeah, you continue.
Yeah, I'm interested in, okay, let's say you invest 30% in me, second and investing 30%, third one, and then we are at 90%. What then? What if an investor comes with which person, he's too late, you know? If I'm gonna do a sellout, like to everyone on the long term, well, what do you think about it? Like I say, first one I do 30%, second again 30, third one again 30%, and after the third guys who invested 30%, I think like, oh okay, bad idea, and then it still all goes all the way, and and that's it. And the next new which are coming are after, let's say, this 1 year you're talking about, Or am I absolutely wrong?
You're absolutely wrong. You're not investing percent. You're investing amount of money for percent of my earnings. You need cash, amount of money. You're paying me. And now, for a year, you're going to get percent of all my earnings.
So it's basically like I'm not selling, it's like staking. You give me money.
You stake for a person, yeah?
Like, look, you give me money, and for X amount of time, you get, like, shares of the company. So basically, you get the dividends of it, if that makes more sense. So basically, for those 2 years, you just get your X amount of money, depending on how good Marshall does. Because, let's say, his stocks go to zero. That means you just got screwed. If his stocks go high, then you're in good luck. So that's pretty much how it works.
Yeah, it's like I said, if like without me, you're gonna earn 1,000, I'm gonna earn nothing. Nothing good, yeah. But if you invest good money in me, and you, like you said, we're gonna get successful. And if you invest proper money with me, you may be sure we're gonna get successful, yeah. So you're gonna get money, and like I said, if we will be exceeding successfully and you will earn super good money, it's still great. It's absolutely great deal with me, because without your money, it wouldn't happen. Like I said, I know the numbers. I'm here for long enough, and in the industry at all, I've hit that threshold. I'm not gonna go any higher without massive amount of investments and bringing the additional value to the content, to increase the quality. Yeah, like I said, we need a massive amount of money to invest in the hardware. We need massive amount of money to invest in a proper stuff. Like the simple intro that we've used costed me a lot of the money for that thing. You know what I mean? These investments. If you want to bring the quality, you need to invest the money. Yeah, and if you're gonna do it like I'm doing it now, slow but steady, I'm growing with that slow and steady pace, very slow and steady pace, yeah? So, like a small amount of money investment is not gonna bring that pace any higher, yeah? Because there's a gap that I cannot jump in. To make that, all that investment that I could plan for a long time would have happened immediately, and all that investment that I planned in the further on would have to happen start now, yeah? So the amount of money you gotta invest is big. So if you're gonna bring me $100,000 tomorrow, yeah, I will tell you that in 2 years you're gonna get it back with a percent.
And tomorrow you go on vacation.
No, that's not gonna happen. We're gonna sign the contract.
Okay.
Yeah? Like I said, we're gonna sign the contract. I'm gonna guarantee you the hours from me. I'm gonna guarantee you the stuff. You know what I mean? This is the, how the investors work. It's like when you're going to work, Twitcher. When you're going to work, you sign the contract, yeah. That when you're going to the work, you're working your hours and you're being paid for that. And this is the same thing. You're investing money with me and I'm doing the job for you partially, yeah? This is the same thing. There's no difference here. But like I said, the amount of that money you would have to invest in any of the streamer is massive. Like Candy said, she need to wait a year to figure out how much she grows, yeah? How much her earnings grows, because she's afraid, yeah? That she would be screwed, you know what I mean? And it's simple. Every single investor will think like that. How to invest in the streamer which I can screw, because that streamer has got the potential, yeah? You got the potential, she's got potential, Sam's got potential, TNT's got potential. Those are streamers I'm investing closed eyes, just like that, yeah? I would think about a couple others, yeah? But that would be very, very, that would be like risk on another level, yeah? Not the gamble for me, you know what I mean? That's for the proper gamblers. There are other streamers that you can invest here, I'm sure, but that gamble is like a risk. You're risking so much that, of course, if you're gonna win, you're gonna win. But how much you're gonna win, this is the question, you know what I mean? If the win will be worth that risk, yeah? Like I said, if you're gonna invest in me $10,000, we're not gonna make it back. No chance.
There's like Beatrice said, if we do, like, it was a set in Theta that, like, 20 people can invest and then say an investment in you, it still will be enough. And I think that's how it will work.
Yeah, it will work, but fine. But now, if you got like Bear said, 100 people, each of them will bring 100,000 TFL. That's not much, yeah? But let's be honest, 100,000 TFL is not like a magic money, yeah? That's even for like amateur investors, it's good, yeah? To do. So like you said, he's gonna bring 100 people, they're gonna invest me, but now that 100 people, every one of them is not gonna earn 30% of the investment, but only 0.3. Yeah, this is very important. So the question is, if they want to invest that kind of money for that kind of comeback, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So, Bear, you are in the business, yeah? Like if you're gonna invest in me 10 millions, yeah, of T-Fuel, you're gonna back 30% on that, yeah? But if you are gonna invest in me 100,000, you're gonna get from that only 0.03. So is it worth for you now freezing that 100,000 T-Fuel?
No.
For that small amount, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but I will still earn 30% from you. I will still earn 30. Yes.
No, if it's full buck, like the T-Fuel.
No, because it's just 100 people. So you got 30% shared between 100 people.
Yes.
So it's only 0.3%.
Yes.
Not 30%.
Yes, but you need to remember that this will be a point of free from 10 million, not from 100,000. I'm still getting my 30% from my 100,000.
No, your 30% goes from my earning, not from your investment.
Yes, from your earnings. Yes.
So, yeah, so if I'm gonna earn 10,000 in a month, 30% from 10,000 is 3,000. And that 3,000 is now gonna be split between 100 people.
Yes, but if you will earn just 10,000, I'm gonna kill you because it's it's gonna be a waste of my time.
Yeah, but that's what I'm talking about. You're not gonna earn from that 3,000. You're gonna earn only 30 T-Fuel, you know what I mean? Because it's 100 people. Yeah. So the question is, if that investor, is it worth for him? Because he's not gonna earn that 3,000, but only 30. So is it worth to freeze, invest in me 100,000 T-Fuel for only 30 income? You know what I mean?
Yes.
That makes much more different. You're not gonna get 30% of that. You're gonna get only 3.3 of the percent. Mm-hmm. That's massive difference.
Small investors.
It's different when one person is getting all. It's different when you're getting a small share of that, yeah?
Mm-hmm. Small capital, small share.
You're right. Yeah, no, this is, okay,
yeah, you,
okay,
wait, wait. You also forget one thing. What if everything will work like you say, just the payout once, you know? Like the T-Fuel pool or giveaway with three items, only one item is working. So you invested and everything is working, but the payout just bugs. What if it will happen? What will you do? Come on. What will you do then? It's just a bug then, you know?
Yeah, but that's on the Theta side, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but on the other hand, I mean, you're gonna be the one blamed because nobody cares.
No. How can I be blamed? This is smart contract. I mean, that's what Theta. But we are sorting out the stuff for you. We're making that work. Yeah. So the complaints about the contracts for them. The complaints about the amounts can be to me. Yeah. Like I've told you that we're gonna earn that and that and that, and we're not hitting the targets. Okay, you're going to me. What the fuck's happening? Yeah. Let's try to sort that. But if I'm earning what we're supposed to earn, yeah, we're growing how we plan that we're gonna grow, but the smart contract got broken. That's not me, that's Theta, and you're going to Theta, and then Theta we're gonna sort it, because Theta is the connector, yeah? This all works together, yeah? So they don't want to make that smart contract being broken, you know what I mean?
Well, I mean, that makes sense, but on the other hand, you see, you can't assume, let me just rephrase. You cannot always expect that the investors are gonna be the smartest people with crypto. So because there's a lot of people, I mean, even Candias can decide to give you, Marshall, $10,000, and then a bug, which is not uncommon on Theta.
no one's gonna say that was spicy.
Items of three disappear.
Yeah. So basically, now Candias, who barely understands what smart contract is, whatever, she only invested in you because, well, she kind of knows you and she expects to get back from you, and now she gets a bug. Who do you think is gonna be the blame person? not it's not gonna be well it's gonna be probably either Tata, it's gonna be either you or it's gonna be both. But since you're since you're the public face, you're gonna get the spit on the face the most.
Yeah, but do you imagine now that investors coming to me and saying I didn't get my share? What happened? So I'm gonna explain. Okay, this is my numbers. My share went for you, no problem, yeah? Further on, what happened with the share? You go for Theta, because Theta is bringing the smart contract, not me. I'm bringing you the content, I'm bringing you the plan, but what happens after the speed is not me, you know? It's like, I'm not the technical engineer, yeah? And that's what they provide, because Theta is earning on that as well. You do understand that.
Yeah, I mean,
that every investor who got to bring that, buy that Tfue, is gonna pump out that, yeah? And there will be a massive PR about that. You know, you understand that, yeah? Because, like I said, we've got the plan, we're gonna grow, we need to market that, we need to advertise that, you know what I mean? So Theta understand that. So they can't screw. Also, I'm more than sure they would not talk about it if they wouldn't be sure of the value of the smart contract. Simple idea, and simple to say it. How, Twitcher, you don't know because you are a streamer, yeah? But the affiliates got the subs, yeah? You can sub to the affiliate, yeah? And you can sub to the partner, yeah? So every sub is a smart contract. Every single sub is a smart contract. How does smart contract work? When you click the subscribe button on his channel, on Heatsink channel, 50% of your Tfue for sub going to Heatsink and another 50% going to Theta Auto. That's how smart contract
works. I don't like
that. Listen, now when you sub to me, yeah? 40% of that soup goes to Theta, 60% goes to me. That's smart.
And if I donate to Heatsink, he will get everything.
Yeah.
Exactly. But this is how I'm trying to explain how the smart contract works, yeah? So Theta is sure that when you invest the money, they put the smart contract, and when you invest, like you said, when you donate me 100 Tfue, 70% will go to me, 30 will go to you, because they know it works. You know what I mean? So far, I don't remember there was any issue with them kind of smart contracts on Theta. We've got issues with everything, but not with that. And I believe they know it works perfect. That's why they offered that kind of solution. Of course, I may be wrong, yeah, but I believe that I'm right, yeah. Did you had any, and that was any single situation when someone souped to you, Heatsink, and the sub speed was wrong?
No. The only problem we ever
had. Wait, we had a problem with that. You can't donate with credit cards.
I've got the problem same. People were taking that they can donate with the credit card for me, and they can't sub with the credit card. I don't know why. But we're talking about the speed. So smart contracts always worked. Split always worked. And Theta knows that. That they can, that like I said, there will be no books. This will always work. There may be books, my chat will not work, yeah? Emotes will not work. Like you said, items will vanish. But split will always work. They know that they can offer that.
Yeah. There's also one thing that probably we haven't covered yet about when it comes to this. Bear Trader, you probably are interested in this as well. So, you know, it says split and all that, but, you know, it's not untypical for like things like smart contracts to have their transaction fees or their like taker fees or whatever you call them for the specific. So I mean, they haven't said yes, but they haven't said no. So who said that Tata is not gonna take a part of that? In case if they even take like 5 to 10%, that means it's even worse for me to invest in you, because now if Bear Trader gives me the 10 mil, he's gonna be way less likely to get his money back, because now Tata is taking like 10% of the initial agreement.
No. They advertise themselves, and you can find it in the white paper and all the info on Theta, that there is very small transaction fees on Theta, yeah? And then transaction fees are always gonna happen, yeah? And that's what the Theta is meaning.
Maybe I will explain. The same situation is when you are trying to buy using gas on Ethereum. So if you are buying, if you are buying using the value about $1 million sending, or you are sending $100, you are paying the same gas fee on Ethereum. So if you will invest in me about 10 million T-Fuel, you will not pay a different fee. So you are investing, for example, 100,000. So if you will invest smaller money, lower money, you will in percent you will pay a bigger fee. But if you invest the amount I want, you'll pay the fee will be in, when you convert to the percents low.
Right.
Yeah, czy mnie zrozumieli?
Well, on the other hand,
I have a question. In this moment, do you really think вот Twitterus, что действительно эта ситуация возможна, что появится инвестор, который будет инвестировать? Вот прямо
okay, she's just asking. At this moment, right now, everybody, Beatrice already answered. Do you think this will be? This will happen, and an investor will really invest in you at this moment, right now. That's the question.
So the answer is no, because we don't know investors.
Yes.
Yeah, but she was asking what you guys think about that.
No, I would say 90% no. If it was right now.
In my opinion, there is a chance because. The 30% we are talking about all the time, it's ustalone pomiędzy inwestorem a streamerem.
Yes, it's set between the streamer and investor. Yeah, but it was example. 30% was example.
Równie dobrze
yeah?
Można być 50 na 50.
Exactly what I said. If you invest in me that 10 million TFU, I will give you 50% for first year and 30% for second. Yeah, so investing for me on 2 years. Yeah. Because there's no other way that we can get the money back in shorter time. No chance, yeah? In 2 years, and 50% is your first year, because I know how much we will grow in the first year. I've got some kind of analysis that I can know how we can grow with the money first year. And I know how much we will grow in the second year. So I know if I will keep that 50% for you in the second year, I will be screwed, yeah? So to make it fair, 50% for you first year, 30% second year for that amount of the investment. So 2 years stayed on. But like the 50% we are talking about is like just an example, yeah? You can sort out with the stream at 10% if it's okay, you know what I mean? But what kind of money you need to invest to get back 10% and yield on it, and it would be worth for both people, for the streamer and for investor.
Right. And really what I wanted to say is not so much the percentage cut that they're gonna take, but I want to really say more of the contract settlement fee, because I think there are, at least I've heard that there are some contracts that you have to like pay in to actually get those. So I think if Tata TV is incentivizing them, I would kind of assume that they want to have a share of the pie as well. I mean, let's be honest, how does Tata even earn their money? From ads? Like, no. What kind of ads are you seeing on the platform?
Tata TV is supposed to
well,
the money from ads.
Supposed to.
Yeah, it's just the business platform, the business of that kind of platform is from selling the ads, yeah? And the more ads they sell, the more ads they show, the more money they get, yeah? Plus, they've got like a very small amount, which is from subs, but this is not something that platform counts, yeah? No platform counts on that, no? Let's be honest. It's not like platform is earning money from that. Platform, the main income from the platform is from the sponsors, from sold ads, yeah? So GFuel, in theory, GFuel pays massive amount of money to Tata, and then we've got a season 4 sponsored by GFuel, ads on the, when you turn on the streamer is from GFuel, you know what I mean? All that stuff. But if Tata will sell the amount of the ads to different companies, they are earning more monies. But to sell that to different companies, they also need more viewers. To have the more viewers, they need to invest more, yeah, to get that reach. So in theory, what happens here in that whole investment in the streamers is like, if investor in will invest in me, it's my job to grow the me and platform together. You know what I mean? It's not anymore Tata job to do that. They don't invest anything. I have to do all the work. You know what I mean?
So Twitcher, you kind of missed the question. Well, not the question, the comment I was doing. So I was saying that.
But Candy, we think that there's no chance it's gonna happen. Yeah, it's a beautiful vision, but the reality is that without knowing the wells, it's not gonna happen.
Yeah, but wait, let me also add something to this. There's one guy at Twitch, I don't know how he's called exactly, but he's donating, always when he's donating, he's minimum donating $5,000 to somebody, like, you know, to nobody. And he's like asking his friends or where he is, like, to who we gonna donate it, you know? I don't know, he's millionaire or something, but this is like the same. He's just coming in and there's a streamer, he has like only 5 to 10 viewers at CSGO or something, and then he just get like $6,000 to $30,000 for nothing in one donation, you know, PayPal donation. It's a real donation, you know, and he's really famous for that. And you could also see this as a smart contract, because this guy who gets this donated, he's like, oh, what the fuck, the next 6 months I can go tomorrow to my boss, shit at his red carpet, and the next 6 months I'm gonna do whatever I want, and I'm not gonna lose my rent, you know, and can pay my rent and everything.
So that, I think that's a short-term thinking.
Why? Don't you think so? Why? If you get one day, you get minimum $6,000 in one day, in one time donation. Yeah. When you get never a donation, never.
No, yeah, like I said, this is a short-term thing, yeah? This is a donation, this is not a business. You don't watch it from the business side, yeah? So you're gonna, Twitcher, you're gonna get donation $6,000 and you're gonna go and tell your boss, fuck off, you know, or something, pardon my French, yeah? But you're gonna do that? No.
Maybe.
Oh, you must be.
Okay, yeah, wait, I will record it for you. I will do it, I will record it for you, and
yeah, but not for that. But it's the same thing. Like I said, it must be the life-changing money. 6,000 is not a life-changing money for you, because that 6,000.
You have 6 months time to think about what will you do next, without worrying how to pay the rent and without worrying how do you get food, because this is the most problem what every streamer has.
Yeah. I agree with that. Okay, you are right. But if that's your approach to the thing, okay, I'm dropping everything and we'll...
Okay, 6,000, please. Months. I will shit my chef's carpet. I will record.
I think that's a very immature approach.
Well, we know where... Let's crowdfund $6,000 for that.
Right. No, but I believe this is an immature approach, you know what I mean? Like a long term, but for short term, you know, that's normal. Yeah, people do lots of mistakes, yeah, and then they will learn on their own mistakes. This is like I've heard the saying, American saying, isn't that our saying? What's the difference between a wise man and a stupid man? And the answer was, the wise man is learning on the mistakes of other people. The stupid man is learning on his own mistakes. Yeah, so simple as that. Yeah, I rather like to learn on your mistake. You're gonna go and do that. And I will not gonna do that. And there was lots of people like you before that get a small amount of money, yeah, win on a lottery or something, like you said, that small amount of money, and they drop the job, and then they went to real trouble because after that they had an issue, yeah. Depends on where are you, yeah. There are different countries, different cultures, stuff like that. But if you will do that stuff like that here in England, you're gonna get yourself a black ticket, yeah. It's like your employer is sending to the government, to the child center, a letter that you did that.
Yeah,
you
but can
the
I...
job. And now when you're going to look for the job, every employer is going to check your job center records and going to say that you said to the boss, fuck off, and you left the job. Nobody will want to employ you. You're screwed. You know what I mean? Learn on other people's mistakes.
Yeah, I understand what you mean, but think about that. Like, most important is like timing. Let's say about timing. Let's say the day Uniswap just gave you $1,000, you know? And the exact the same day, my friend told me this, and he said, now you have to go there and there. And I said, now I'm at fucking work for 8 hours. And I thought maybe in 8 hours later, I won't have the time. And it's the timing. Every time something important happens, you are at work, you know? Or I pre-order it Serious Sam two months ago, I wanted it so hard to play it, and exactly yesterday it comes out, and I need to do, I had all the week free, and exactly yesterday when it comes out, I had to work yesterday, I have to work tomorrow, and I have to work on Sunday 12 hours, and that's the timing, you know, that's the secret timing, every time, how to say properly, I think I said it really like properly, you know, like, and if I would have...
Karma is a biatch.
Okay, I'm not gonna say anything more, but you understand what I mean. It's the timing, yeah, you know, and yeah. Always when something important happens, you are not there.
This is karma zabijacz. You need in situations like you're talking about, you just need a bit of luck, yeah? Am I right? Yeah, because this is not like you said that it's gonna happen, that you could, some things you can't just plan, yeah? It will happen because it will happen, yeah? Could you back in time, let's say 2 months ago, did you know that Ultra is gonna sign a deal with Teta, and did you know that Ultra is gonna sign a deal with the Atari? Nobody knows, so you couldn't plan it, you know what I mean? It just happened and you are too late, simple as that, yeah? This happened, this stuff that you can't plan, yeah? But now, like today, you can see that Ultra then done them deals, they are pushing the marketing, so you can think, so maybe they would like to plan and get something else in them surrounding subjects, so maybe it's worth to get the token, invest, you know what I mean, because it will grow up, and that's what you can plan. But you couldn't plan that, like you said, that moment that already happened. It happened, we are too late, yeah, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's, and now imagine you invest $6,000 in me, and now I have, like, instead of going to work every day, the 8 hours, it's like my friend said, instead of working 8 hours, imagine, checking crypto out 8 hours a day. And he said, after 2 years, you will be rich. And I said, yeah, cool story, bro. I still need to work 8 hours a day, you know? But he did it already. Maybe I have a whale friend. Maybe he will invest in me. I will write about it to him.
You see? That's what we're talking about. You just find out that you got a friend that's invested, then you can make some... But there you go.
But the main thing he said, instead of going to work for working for somebody, you would really sit 8 hours a day and really investing something of crypto, you would do the money, you know? You would do the money,
yeah.
But...
Yeah? And he's right?
Yeah, he's right.
It's the same with streaming. Do you think if you're gonna go and stream once a week for 2 hours, you're gonna do the money? No, mate, you're not. But like you said, if you're gonna do it every day for 8 hours, instead of working every day of 8 hours, you love it enough to do it every day for 8 hours, sooner or later, with slowly you grow, but to do that, to grow that, you need support from like we both said, or everyone said, you need support from our side. So if, let's say, you are like many streamers living in a mommy's basement, yeah, I don't want to, or living many of streamers got support, yeah, let's say some got the family, yeah, we've got like a streamer that got the family, yeah, the wife is working, let's say streamer is streaming, wife is working, yeah, they got no kids, wife's got the job, so the bees are covered, he can focus on streaming, yeah? That is he able to do that? Yeah. But you are a single person who's paying the tax, all the bees for yourself. For you, it's much more difficult. Am I right? It's different. It's different for
me. If I would have a wife, I think it would be even harder for me.
Let the bear talk. He has something to say about this.
But look at Heatsink.
Yeah?
You've got the support from your family. You're not paying the bills for whole flat by yourself at the moment, yeah?
Technically, I'm not paying whole amount, but I'm paying a good chunk of it, so... It's almost... I pay almost the same, like, a bit less than renting a room a month. But, yeah, it's still easier than that, to be honest.
So... In your case, if you would chat with your family, whatever, I don't know how it's your setup there, and tell them, you know, I've decided my fate, I'm gonna stream 8 hours every day, yeah? Would you gonna support me in that? Do you think they will? No. So you can't make that choice. But some people can't. Simple as that, yeah? It's like you said, not everyone can do it. Like you Twitter, you like you said, 8 hours on that crypto. Can you afford doing that 8 hours on that crypto like right now?
But again, what? Can I afford?
Can you drop your job from today and start doing that crypto 8 hours there from tomorrow? Can you do that? No, because you won't be able to pay your bills for next year or two until you get to that moment when you, like you said, you're gonna start earning reasonable money. Am I right?
Sure.
Yeah? But if there would be someone in your house, your parents or your partners or whoever, who is earning and supporting you, so you can do that, because they know that in 2 years you're gonna earn money, would you do that?
Wait. Let's take Rising Flame. He was a really big streamer here. He's on Twitch now. I'm still watching him sometimes, and he got like... yeah, like no viewers. And he said before he left Teta, he said like I got money problems and I got a child and we need money now. And now he's at Twitch, you know. And yeah, his wife is supporting him, and it's not going good. It's not going good.
Because it's never easy.
Yeah,
you think it's easy for me?
Yeah, but if it's not going good, you still say okay, I'm gonna still play 8 hours a day computer like streaming.
Well, it depends on I think this depends on person. Yeah, it's like do you
yeah,
think
but
it's easy
what
for
would
me?
Your wife say after 1 month you earned only like let's say at which $30? What would she say? What do you think? Can you ask question of you? If I'm your you're living with me and I say I am the man in the house and next month I bring you from Teta $30 and I would say yeah. What would you tell me?
Please translate for me.
Если я твой муж, если я твой муж, я говорю, я зарабатываю, как стримовать, и через месяц, когда нам надо все заплатить, и квартиру, и кушать, и все-все-все, я принес $30. Что ты скажешь? По-английски скажи им, пожалуйста.
Fucking shit.
Come on, Candy. That's a serious that's a serious question. Would you kick him out from the home?
But now I'm in this situation as one person of couple. But my boyfriend терпит меня.
Oh my god!
I know this. Problem.
Yeah, but you have to be realistic. Let's say, okay. Let's say I'm gonna quit my job tomorrow. I'm gonna stream tomorrow 8 hours on Teta, you know. And let's say it still will be shit. It will be still like $30 at the next payout. What will I do? I will go rob somebody, or I will sell my bag or something. I don't know. What will I do? You know?
Black market.
I need to translate, sure. This is very difficult for me, really. Now I understand some words, but no understand sense. I'm very sorry.
Yeah, KGS is doing English cards today with us, for free.
Yeah.
Really good.
Tuche, you see, you explain it wrong. Explain it easier, yeah? Explain that it's theory. It's theory, it's not real, yeah? Theory. You, Twitcher, your husband, you are wife to Twitcher, you are working full time in office or whatever you are doing.
I told her exactly
but
that.
And Twitcher,
wait, I told her
Twitcher,
she's not working. I told her she's not working. If she will work, she will instantly kick me out if I bring $30.
No, but that's your point of view. That depends on the household.
Okay,
ask some people will support each other. How do you know that the other person will not support you? Why do you...
Because at home it's always about money.
No. Well, so now you're talking about the partnership, but the business deal, yeah?
That's the woman side of you, yes. Mostly, yeah.
Unbelievable. To Witcher, I personally think, but this is a personal opinion, yeah? That absolutely, there's no analysis from that. I've got no data about that. The personal opinion is like, that anything can happen because each of us is different and each of us got different living situation. Yeah? Look at me. I'm a single father. I've got a 9-year-old kid, one daughter, yeah? Which cost me absolutely fortune. And I'm earning absolutely shit from here, yeah? And I'm doing that for 1 hour. But I'm not doing that absolutely only thing. I've got side stuff that I'm doing that support me enough money so I can do it what I'm doing, you know what I mean? And if I would have a partner who would be working and bringing additional amount of money, I could push that additional amount of money into bringing that to another level to grow more and to bring money back, you know what I mean? But I don't have, so I'm limited with what I'm doing. Simple as that. Look at me. But like I said, this is not the only thing. I didn't say to my contractors, screw you, you know what I mean? Absolutely not. I haven't done like that. I didn't done the situation like you proposed. Oh, I'm gonna go to my boss and shit him on the red carpet and that's yeah. No, I haven't done anything like that.
That's
yeah?
my dream. Simple that's my that. Dream. Crowdfund me, Tita. Crowdfund me, please.
but this is a different thing. What I'm doing is a contract. Yeah, this is a different thing. I'm not doing anymore. 89 and stuff like that. I used to, but I'm not doing that for a long time now. Yeah, whatever I'm doing like it like on a weekend, one weekend, one night, 2 days, one day. You know, I mean, this is a random stuff. One contract. Spend time, focus on that. Don't get money. Simple as that. Yeah. So it's different. It's a different story. And I know that what I'm doing with the amount of the contracts I'm getting is enough to support me to do what I'm doing here. Without that, that would be absolutely impossible. It would be impossible. There's no chance that I could do stay here on Theta and even only from Theta. I would already be dead from starving. You know what I mean? I've got a kid. Kid's got to eat. It's got to get the new shoes every couple months. You know what I mean? She new dress. She's growing. You know, this is a lot of the cost. Yeah. She needs to eat. And I can eat shit. Yeah. But that's a kid, and you don't want to feed your kid shit, you know what I mean? So you use your brain. Can you do that? No, fucking no, I can't. You know what I mean? I have to make sure that whatever I'm doing here cope with whatever I'm doing there to make enough to have a living, yeah? Maybe we're not going on the holidays because we can afford that, yeah? I'm not buying top-notch equipment because I can't afford that, you know what I mean? But we're not starving. Yeah, she's dressed. I'm dressed. She's got everything. Nothing. She's not going with the limo to the school. We have to walk. Yeah, we're walking back from school. So you know what I mean. But there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with that. You can sort it out if you want. The question is, what do you want to do? If your approach is, I don't give a shit. Well, that's only your approach. And if something goes wrong with your approach, you can blame only yourself. Simple as that. Yeah? If my approach will not work, I can blame only myself because I took that. I took that risk, yeah? I've dropped a sweet job to do that because I knew that the side contracts plus that would be enough to very, very, very gentle and stable life. You know what I mean? I can't afford the car. Impossible. There's no chance. I can't save them. I can't save them. I'm leaving. Like
you will trust me, Marshall. You will.
But at the moment, like I say, I'm leaving from month to month. But she's got everything she needs, yeah. And we've got bills paid. We're leaving. We're going forward. We're working hard. She supports me all the time, yeah. Yeah, she's happy. She believes in what I'm doing. What do you want more? What do you want more? You can do it if you want, but like I said, everyone is different. You don't have daughter that's supporting you. You don't have the girlfriend or wife that's supporting you, you know what I mean? You are at the moment that's like Sam. So the only people who's supporting you is I'm supporting you, bro. Yeah? You and me, homie, and I will be supporting you even if you will be still shit talking, you know what I mean? I will still be supporting that Mike eating in top right corner heatsink, yeah? Look, he's waiting when we called him to the chat. He even mute himself and think he won't. We not see that. Well, we can see that. He think we see everything.
Ah, now I understand the background you were talking about.
Yeah, sure. You want to listen to everything I say in the background, do you?
Wait. You three guys are from Poland, right?
No.
Wait. Pietrader is in Poland. From... You were from Poland, and he think.
No, he thinks from Cambodia.
Cambodia, okay.
Bangladesh. No, Bangladesh.
That was a joke, Twitter!
We'll be not. Right, well, anyways, I'll need to leave because I'm short on time right now, so I'll just catch up on the stream, I guess.
We still love you, yeah. We still love you. Don't forget to share with us.
Sure.
Well, anyway, you want to say that after you had to mute yourself to chat in the background, you gotta leave us and you're not gonna share with us?
No.
you can do the business. You see, Twitcher, how you do the business? Everything for yourself, like he said. Right, Hitzing, if you're leaving us, can you tell everyone where they can find you?
Right, so basically it's on t.tv/Hitzing77, and you can always check me on Twitter, the same username.
Thank you very much. Hope to catch you on next one. Have a good night, and we will be dreaming how you're sharing with us. You know?
Ah, sure. That's the last thing I want. Right, see you then.
See ya, good night.
See ya.
Yeah, but this is basically how it is. Bear.
Yes?
Why do you stream?
Because it's fun.
Wait, Bear, how can I follow you? I never saw you streaming on Twitter.
Oh.
Yeah.
Because you are not watching crypto channels.
I'm doing, but it's all like fake crypto channels. Like, I'm from Binance, I'm from Bybit, I'm from blah blah, but at the end it's like just a video which goes 40 minutes, and after 40 minutes the same video restarts. Why should I watch it? Like, why?
You should not watch it.
Yeah, but I still checked it, but I didn't see you.
Because I'm streaming different hours. You are at work then.
Okay, I still try to follow. Yeah, I wanted to ask you, what do you think about Theta? What's your most concern about Theta? Most concern about Theta. And I was listening to the podcast with Kyle Luffy, or yeah, like
yes,
yesterday, yeah. And he said like
but crypto podcast, the one I provided,
and yeah, which you provided, and he was saying like what was very good podcast, and he said like 50 cent will be only a glimpse which we have for now, you know, and today we have like the 68 cents. I wanted to ask you, what are your most concerns about Theta, and what you believe will be the most good ones or on the long term?
What can I say? I'm not playing all. I never play $2. I just play with Bitcoin. So if we are talking about the price of Theta, you need to convert this to Satoshi, and in my opinion, it will be worth about even 40,000. So it can be $4, $10, something like that.
Even there, if there's a 1 billion, like coins of it, yeah. Okay.
But the question is also, like I said, was the main concept about the concern about the Theta. So what's your main concern? What do you think is an issue? What will be an issue? Yeah. What's the problem? Do you see any problems here?
Na razie za mało widzów. To jest podstawowy problem.
So the small viewership.
Yes.
Smooth viewership. Well, all right. Twitcher, what's your concern about Theta? What's the biggest issue?
My concern is the 1 billion Theta, the backholder, you know. Let's say you have Theta at Binance, you have Theta at...
Okay, but what kind of influence does that have on Theta TV?
On the price.
Oh, so
I'm talking about crypto now, about Theta. Not,
what kind of concept you got about?
Yeah, so if you're buying Theta, there's always a backholder, and you don't know who the backholder is. It could be the developer, it could be the creator, it could be the programmer. You never know, you know. And you don't know how much he's holding since the start. Yeah, I know it's open source, and you can watch like everything. But still, we had it much time before that. I give an example. There's one coin. There's one coin. I don't know. It's called. Wait. It's called 888, and it was at one Satoshi, and it got pumped up to five Satoshis, and at the end it was like at 4.5 million market cap at the end. Sorry. And the people were asking, why is it always? It's at one Satoshi. Every time it goes from one Satoshi to five Satoshi, and it goes to 4, 3, 2, and 1. And then we have to pump it again, and it goes from 3 to 2, 1. And at the end, if you watch the Explorer from the ERC-20 token, you see that the main backholder is holding all the tokens. So even if it's worth 4.5 million or whatever, the backholder, he got like an unlimited supply of this, you know. And the people are asking, why is it dumping? Why is it dumping all the time? I don't understand. I don't understand. Yeah.
But isn't it that, who's asking?
Everybody's asking who's investing in it. And he invested at 1 satoshi and thinks like, oh, even it goes, even if it goes to 2 satoshis, I would have 100%. Oh my god, you know, it's just a shitcoin. It's just a shitcoin, you know. And
yeah, but okay, why do you invest in shitcoin?
I didn't invest in this shitcoin.
So why do you bother?
Because you don't know who's the backholder, who's selling it, and how much he owns.
Again, why do you bother?
Because.
You know who, but you know who's the backholder.
It's the same like we talk. We take your.
You know who's the, but you know who is the backholder.
Wait, if we take your token, let's say we take PO69, you know, and it will be listed on 4 exchanges, and people will buy it. Everybody will buy it, and then one day you decide, you know what? I don't want to do with this anymore. Today I'm gonna. How much tokens there are, of PO69? You decide to drop like all tokens in one day. Yeah. Yeah. What if you decided, and? You know? What if you die tomorrow? What will happen to it? You know, that's the question I always have, like.
But in case of Theta, it's a company. It's
not a company. I know. I'm just giving them example, and this is like my main concern. And I hope
but, like I said, but you talked about Theta, so like I said, Theta is a company, it's a different thingy. Yeah, than the private token.
Yeah, we were talking about my concern. That's my
okay.
Main.
So look at
so
the
you're confident that you don't know who is the back person from the Theta. From Theta is a company. Not
yeah,
the
but there like... could be one backholder with I don't know 500,000 tokens.
No, but the, but, could the, be... but you know, when you go on, a... no, it is impossible because Theta's got like a proper.
I know.
Keeping the tokens.
But we had it before. Yeah. We had it before the same like. Yet the hierarchy, how is it based and everything, and at the end, it dropped to 0 satoshi. Still, somehow, magically, you know.
But listen to what Bertelli said. Bertelli said, "Who is the backholder of the euro?"
US dollar, and the US dollar.
Euro. He's using euro. So who is the backholder of the euro?
Yeah, it's the same. Like if you would accept PO69 tomorrow on 4 exchanges. On 4 exchanges, and it would be traded, and everybody would say today it's $1. Oh my god, it's even cheap. Maybe it will go up to $8. I'm gonna buy, you know, and then something would start to move, you know.
Yeah, but
it's always a gambling.
Gambling. Yeah, it's simple as that. It's a gamble. There is nothing else here, but there are projects that are much more like Theta. Yeah. You've got a staking, you've got nodes, you've got a full blockchain that's working, proof of concept, TV. This is a fully working, like I said. You've got fully working token and blockchain, yeah? Which is Theta blockchain is fully working, yeah? We've got Theta TV, we've got share embeds, we've got partners where they are embedding them content, and they are, like, you can go and watch Theta TV on GFuel website, yeah? And you can use their account to use the Theta TV. Use their partnership account, their GFuel account, not the Theta TV account, yeah? Everything works. Fully working token. You've got fully working contracts. You've got fully working donations, earnings, upload sharing, you know what I mean? All is working. You've got the stakings, yeah? So who's getting the main token, staking in the Guardian nodes, sharing the connection, making a piece, earning from the stake, GFuel, you know what I mean? Everything's working. And that token is worth less. Both tokens are worth less than many of the shit coins that got absolutely nothing. Absolutely nothing. Look how expensive now is Sun token, yeah? Which is absolutely shit crypto. It's if you go and check white paper of Sun token says Sun token is a crypto project that is testing the smart contract that when you're gonna stake Tron, you're gonna earn Sun. That's it. Nothing else. We've got no idea what we're gonna do for it. It's absolutely useless. Nobody's got any use for that.
Like every project of Justin Sun. Every project of Justin Sun.
Announcement from the announcement. Welcome to crypto.
But that's what we're talking about. There is no use of that, and it's expensive. So there's no point of even from my point of view, there's no point of touching the subject. Yeah, Because that's absolutely amazing gamble. People are pumping the token that's got no value at all. No usefulness at all. While you got a Theta token and TPU, which are absolutely fully working, and they are not pumped like that. Because there is no gamble here, yeah? This is like a proper working stuff. There's not so much gamble, so there's no much jumps and downs, yeah? But Sun token, there's no useful for that. Everyone knows there's absolutely no use of that. So everyone is pumping that gamble, waiting for the moment when it starts to be dumped, and everyone wants to be dumped and earn and screw everyone else. That's how it works. That's it. Gamble. There's no other reasonable thing. Let's pump it as much as we can, and let's keep our fingers crossed that we are better than everyone else, and we will dump it before everyone else and screw everyone else. That's how it works. That's not the platform. Theta TV is a platform. Theta TV is a feature. If they will be doing the good stuff like they are doing, I'm sure we will be top four. And I'm sure that everyone who will stay with Theta, with the project, with the platform, will definitely win.
Yeah, I think there will be definitely life-changing situations at Theta. I'm 100% sure. That's why I also invested like $300 today. It's not much for like maybe bear trader. For me, it's much. And I'm really looking for the long term on it.
Yeah, simple as that. Simple as that. Theta is absolutely something amazing. But Theta is working already and it's got the plans for future. And as we can see, we just got an update. Yeah? Platform was just updated. Yeah? And what happened when platform was updated? Candy, do you like the changes, the new Theta?
I wrote in the TNT chat that I don't like changes. Вообще, I don't like changes.
Yes.
But I understand what is not a true way. But changes is a way for the better. Yes, but sometimes it difficult. Sometimes it's difficult, uncomfortable, неприятно, but
this
no
is,
changes,
this is why
no grow. Without changes, no grow.
Yeah, simple. And she understands that. And that's why I said, you hear what she said, what Candy said. I would absolutely invest with her. Now, Bear, what do you think about the new update on Theta TV?
No comment.
No, you can be honest. Yeah, I don't know. What do you think about the changes?
Piece of shit. So maybe I will not say anything else, okay?
Alright, Twitch, what do you think about the changes?
How is it called in English? Weird description, is it wise or I'm not sure. What do I think? I tried to raid Kirkus like 3 times. Oxyroth was raiding me with 80 people, and it shows like you got raided, but the people still stay at the other channel. Chico Crypto was streaming, and I'm not sure he tried to raid somebody, but he was mad because he ended the stream, but the people was hyping him so hard that still like 300 people stayed at his channel, even when he was offline and was asking, what's happening, what's going on? He was writing like, what the fuck? I said, I'm going off, you know? And still people were writing about him, asking questions, but he decided to stop it, you know? And what do I think about the new update? The raid function is not working. Donation. There was something wrong with the donations. I can do properly predictions now, when I stream. Sometimes I have to click 3 times. Wait, let me check.
Do you like the new variant of Raffle?
Or
I don't like it. Very, very uncomfortable.
The new raffle, the new way that the...
Yeah, it's absolutely hiding the raffle. So people, if they know how it works, they just join it and do it fast and you're late. And you know how to win the Theta giveaways fast? When you wake up in the morning at 8 and you are the first one when the giveaway starts, you have the most high chances. That's like I win the most, you know, when I wake up in the morning and I join the giveaways. But at the end, when you don't know it and when you join late... if you don't know it, you just can join it. And it's like one little thing you need to click just to do it. Yeah, come on. Why do you do it extra hard? Why? Why do we have to do it like rocket science? Come on. There has to be a reason for it.
No, but from my point of view, I do understand that you don't like that the raffles giveaways are small down there, yeah? But from my point of view, yeah, as being here for such a time gap to some moment, I'm happy with that. I think it's one of the best changes, to be honest. And I will try to explain why. Because now, giveaway is not your main content. Now you are your main content.
No, no, still, if Nemco comes to your channel and he says, I want to drop, he still knows exactly where to click and he will ask the same question. It changes nothing.
Yeah, but... Yeah, but wait, give me a second. Now we are growing, yeah, and we want to grow. We want to bring new viewers. And when the new viewer, when you are bringing here new viewers, why do you bring them here? Because you can give them free stuff? Because no. That's how you advertise the platform? That because you can play in a raffle? That's how you advertise? Oh, do you tell them, I'm doing absolutely the best in the West show on Terra TV. Hell yeah, yeah! You join Marshall Draco channel for a one-of-a-kind podcast with the best content creators on the platform for absolutely great training us, for crazy projects, for valuable info. That's why you join Terra TV, for absolutely one-of-a-kind stuff. Yeah! Marshall Draco in the posse, we are the best in the West. No questions asked, no strings attached. That's why you bring, not for that bullshit supply drops or the raffles.
But still, the bots that were before here, they still know where to click. That's what I'm talking
about. Okay, okay, but is this your main concern? Because I'm not bothered about them. They are not the valuable members of your community. They are not the valuable viewers, you know what I mean? They don't bring a value to you. So you don't bother about them, yeah? You should be happy that it's now you can focus on yourself.
Wait, the second thing, when I watch the stream right now, I don't have I have bad internet, so I have only 5 megabyte download and 3 megabyte upload or so, something about like that. I have bad internet, so I can't choose 720p to 360p. I can't choose it now. So I'm just watching your channel and you're in the middle of a talk and then it just stops and I'm and it's back and you're not talking about anymore. You know, I don't have the choice. I don't have the choice to do it. You know, like before. That's
oh yeah, I agree. This is something I'm also disappointed.
I really like to listen to it. You know, I want even when I'm doing something on over a screen or something, or I'm working on something, I still want to listen to it. And when it just stops and you don't have the choice to change it, yeah, no comment.
Yeah, and I absolutely agree with that. I do not understand why there is no change of the. Of the resolution there, I don't know, no idea. I've got no idea. I think this is a bug. I'm sure this is not a feature. Yeah, I think this is a bug, and I hope it's gonna be fixed. Yeah. So okay, this is a bug. Yeah. I hope this is the what I don't like about the feature about the new update. I personally, but this is only my personal opinion. Don't like about the update. There is no info. It should be okay, we've released the update and known books, that's the features. So now let's say we don't know if this is the book that you cannot change, or we don't know if this is how they plan it to do. Do you know that? No, because there's no information about it. You know what I mean? And that's what I'm missing, yeah? I would be okay if they would tell everyone, yeah, in announcement, there is no more resolution changing on any channel, yeah? We decided that the way you stream, the way it goes, yeah? Okay, so everyone knows, but now we don't know. Maybe it's a book. I think it's a book, yeah? I think it's a book and then they're gonna fix it. But there's no information. That's what I don't like the channel. Same, there should be information about other stuff, yeah?
Yes, same with the giveaway. Same with the giveaway. I was watching your stream with the new update, I was clicking everything I could, where's the giveaway? Or I was checking everything. And the only thing I could find is a report streamer. Yeah, bravo, come on. Yeah, wow.
but I absolutely agree with that and like I said, from my point of view, there should be, this is our features. Everything else that we don't mention is most probably book, so please report that, yeah? And now we know what to report, yeah? But now we don't even know what to report. I don't know if lack of the change of resolution is a feature or is the book, yeah? Maybe it's a book. And maybe it's the how they want it to be. Nobody knows because there's information.
I'm not a professional, but I think if they have one resolution, another resolution, it costs channel traffic. It costs them, like, you know, to stream. Yeah, that's why. And if they choose one, they have to pay only one. Same like for servers, dedicated servers you play, you know. But if you, but you can take like the lowest for the poor, let's say poor people or really far away people, and then the highest, like let's say Oxyroth is streaming on 10 ATP and streaming on, I think like 7 Mbits the second. It's impossible to watch the stream now for me. Impossible.
Yeah,
impossible.
Yeah, that's why I lowered, because it was impossible. But it's not your fault of your connection. I figured out that it's the problem with the CDN, how it shares the content. Yeah, because you can check. Yesterday we had a situation. This is absolutely super confirming. Yeah, yesterday we had a situation that you can see my stream on two different platforms. Yeah, you can see my stream on other platform and on Theta, and you can see that on other platform it's perfect. On Theta, it's lagging, you know, it's starting, stopping. On the other, no problem at all, you know what I mean? So this is clearly some technical issue here, probably after the change and after lack of that resolution, maybe something happens there and they need to be sorted out, yeah? Because it wasn't like that before. Before the update, yeah, we didn't have any issues here. And I, like I said, I didn't change any settings, yeah? So if you don't change settings, everything was good and now it's bad, that's definitely not your fault, yeah, you know what I mean? This is the fault of the somewhere else, yeah? So probably while we're adding more channels and everyone, because everyone sees, it's more streamers. There's much more streamers than there used to be, yeah? It's more streamers, but that also goes with that there's less viewers, yeah? So because the viewers that we got are separated and, you know, they're sharing the same amount of their viewer base between more channels. So maybe because there's more channels, it's too heavy. I don't know. It's difficult to say because there's no official information. That's what I said. From the update, what I don't like, yeah, I don't like that we don't know what's okay and what's not. It should be a simple information. Yeah, because we don't know.
How exactly
do we know if it's okay? Yeah, this is one thing. Like I personally, like I said, I think that the giveaway is in the bottom. I like it. Yeah, I'm super cool. I would be disappointed if we taken completely off here, yeah, but because that is not there. But what I don't like is that this giveaway, that icon, it appears only when you create the giveaway. When you don't have the giveaway, there is no icon there, yeah?
Yeah.
So for the normal viewer, it's confusing, yeah? It's not the same thing, I think. Another confusing thing is when you draw the giveaway, yeah, and the prizes go on, yeah, there is no way anymore to check how many tickets you had.
I can tell you from last week where also the new version.
But I don't know if this is future or if this is book.
Wait, last week I was streaming and I had like a GeForce Star ticket and two other items, like three items to give away. And I was streaming over 6 hours, and I was streaming from the morning to like 4 p.m. or something. So I had like over 100 viewers this day who joined, I think, this giveaway. And at the end, I drew the giveaway, and the only thing what worked was the emote, you know, and the GeForce Star ticket disappeared and the crate disappeared, you know. And I was asking always from the start, well, what is it wrong? What am I doing wrong that the giveaways were not working, you know? Not that it has to work every time, but they're just disappearing. They're not in my item list anymore, so they just disappear, you know. And last time I was streaming, I asked Oxyroth once, what is wrong about it? And he said, it's because you're streaming only 3 hours, 4 hours, and not enough viewers are joining for this giveaway and competing against each other. I said, okay, so I'm gonna stream longer, like 4 to 6 hours. And it worked most of the time. But now, like I said, only the emote of 6 hours streaming. I'm pretty sure there was not only one viewer entering this giveaway, you know. I don't want to cry. It's still awesome. Everything is awesome. But it shouldn't be, you know.
I tried to explain. There is important thing that people not noticed. And we figured it out in the last days, like you said. There was an issue with the chat. And when you draw the giveaway, because there is no more option to check who won, yeah? You can't check anymore who won. It's only what you see in your chat, yeah? But the chat was broken and it didn't show properly the won. So we've done it on my channel. I've drawn the giveaway and it's shown only one person won one prize, yeah? But two other people also won the prizes. It just didn't show it here. But these people won. We didn't know who won, yeah? Until that person was still alive and told me, oh yeah, I got the prize.
Yeah, but we are in 2020. Come on. Why? Question is why?
Books, yeah? Books. But my question is, I think the chat is not working. It shouldn't happen anymore, yeah? But my question is, if it's intentional that we cannot see them tickets anymore, or is the book as well? I don't know, because there is no information. That's what I'm disappointed on. Yeah, but Bear, how do you think about that giveaways now? What's your take off on them hiding on the bottom of the screen? How much you use them?
Giveaways?
Is it like, yeah, them raffles?
Participating in the giveaways from streamers.
What can I say? After 6 weeks when my giveaway doesn't work because I clicked draw giveaway and my giveaway is still drawing. 6 weeks later the draw was closed and someone finally won the rewards from my giveaway. I am not using it at all. And I am giving those crates to active chatters. So I'm not.
I have this problem. I never had that problem, but I have that problem with Paul. So I opened one Paul and it says yes, no, and then I can't close it. And then I realized if I open a new one, the old one will close. Then I created one, the old one closed. Then I created one second, I had two. And then I can't close the old ones. It just says create new poll. So I have now for 3 months, I have two polls now running and I can't close it. I think Candy S had the same problem once, right? Yeah.
Did you report that to the admins, to the staff?
No, yeah. I have things to do.
So 20, if you encounter a book
20 times reported my.
Yeah, I know you did, but
I reported over, you know, things like 100 times and nothing happened. Or happened too late, so I didn't even ask for pods. It's not an important.
So this is the issue. The issue is not the book. The book is the lack of.
And now imagine I invest $10,000 in you and then we have books like these, you know?
But we had the books and we're still here. Because we love what we're doing, yeah? That yes. Small issues that we're getting, treat them as a challenge, you know what I mean? Go above that, yeah? Just, come on. If a small, simple thing like that is gonna break you.
Yeah, BearTrader, like I said, is still giving away his giveaways and items. Mm-hmm. Perfect. Like, he found a way. I also found a way. And CandyS also found a way. So we're still going, you know?
I have very interesting problem. I can't put item from my inventory on a giveaway, not grand giveaway, on usual giveaway. And I wrote about this, but no answer. My inventory looks like picture, this and the item non-active when I try to put item on the giveaway.
Well, I will cut that piece and I will send it to Kyle with maybe he will do about it. I will send him some questions. Hopefully he will answer us and we'll touch them questions.
Who actually listened to this bad cryptocast with Kyle Luffy? Who actually?
That's why I provided it, yeah? And Kyle Luffy on the Bad Crypto Podcast said that we are going, and that Crypto Podcast is quite outdated. It's not fresh, you know what I mean? And he said that Teta would like to get out from the coins and give away.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Yeah, you hear that?
I really enjoyed that one, that podcast.
Yeah, well done. The only thing I did not like there was when the people from Bad Crypto Podcast asked Kyle, oh, but we are not earning T-Fuel on the Teta while we were watching. And what Kyle said? Download the Edge node.
Yeah, and they say they downloaded it and they have it running. And I actually also downloaded it and wanted to do it, but it was too much work for me to like execute it and end it. But I'm still thinking about it.
but this was the biggest disappointment for me. How can you close the issue like that? Oh, download the, this is the only thing that was disappointed, yeah? Oh, oh, if that isn't working for you, just download the edge node, you know what I mean? Yeah, download the edge node.
Yeah, she also, also it said like a TFU pool. She said, yeah, and as a streamer, you get from the TFU pool something, you know, and you can get a payout as a streamer. Yeah, I'm a streamer, I can't get a payout, you know. Some things were bad, some things, but still, and the main podcast was awesome. And I would like to see more from this guy. But I never see him at the theater. Why? Why?
But because you're looking, Bronk. Do you know that he's got his own channel?
On no. YouTube?
And that he's recording videos how to get sponsorship. Do you know who's Kyle in Theta? Kyle is the head of sponsorship and partnerships.
I have him on Twitter. I have just have him on Twitter, man. That's it.
He's not. You gotta check his Twitter. He's always tweeting his videos and stuff like that. Yeah, he's doing absolutely amazing content. Kyle is doing. He's got a great experience and he's doing amazing content. Yeah, and I believe the only thing is like that. I think he takes too much on himself, yeah? You know what I mean? Like, there is no proper stuff. Like Candy said, she reported that she's got an issue and there's no answer, yeah?
Yeah, but you forgot like, one thing. There's Kyle and there's the coder, the programmer, you know? And when there is a bug, the coder, it will take time and he has nothing to do with Kyle.
I pray, sir, yeah. Guys. This is 2 a.m. for me.
Yeah, we're wrapping up. Yeah, we got you. All right. We'll be wrapping in a moment. Just while you're leaving us, tell everyone, Candy, where they can find you.
Where can find me? On the TV. And the link under my Grand Giveaway. Link where.
To your other channel.
Yes.
Alright, so if you want to jump on
this.
Yeah, if you want to find the Candies and drop her a follow on Teta.tv / Candies, CANDYS, and scroll down for her grand giveaway. There are her other social media channels where you can follow her.
Yes. Thank you very much.
Bye,
Kenny. Nice to be in such company. Very pleasure for me. Have a good time. Thank you. Bye bye.
Right, I completely forgot what we were talking about, but I still love you, guys. I absolutely love you. Yeah, she's so charming. She absolutely knocked out the the subject. But yeah. That was a good time. I hope that what you bring. Oh, I know.
Next time I would use the same tactic. If you ask me something, I would say, wait, I have a question.
Ah, you cheeky breaky. Gotcha. Now you screw that because that was the fast that you told me what you're going to do. but yeah, Kyle is doing all of the content. You got to do some more digging, yeah, and you will find out, yeah.
Like I said, podcast was awesome. It was 50 minutes or 57 minutes, and like I really enjoyed everything he was talking about.
Yeah, but see, not many people seen that, yeah. I've tried to set it to as many because this was important subject to touch, yeah. So that's why I provided the link so everyone can listen to it and then adjust to what he said and what was the questions and what was the approach, yeah. So this is what I see personally as a valuable content, yeah. Simple as that. But that's it. We already overdid it, so most probably we have to cut it down later in a small bits. But I think it will be for us enough for tonight. We overdid it because TNT overslept, laying away. That lazy lad was laying awake so long that it's absolutely amazing.
Yes.
Twitter, you're forgiven. You were in work, you know. They're forgiven. But this is the last time you were forgiven.
Oh, shit.
Still love you, homie. Thank you very much. Twitter, can you tell everyone where people can find you?
Yeah, you can find me at Teta at Twitcher at 653 or at Twitcher US, Twitcher Rus. Whatever, and maybe I'm gonna stream Zero Sam 4 now, maybe for only 2-3 hours. and tomorrow I'm gonna like end the game. I don't know how long the gameplay will be, but I'm really, really excited about this game.
Cheers, thank you very much, Bertrader. Where people can find you?
You can find me on Twitter, Bertrader Nick, or you can find me on Teta, and the same Nick, Bertrader.
Wait, I need to find you on Twitter, Trader?
Bertrader.
Trader Beer.
And this guy?
Trader Beer 2 and Trader Beer 1?
No, Bear Trader. Bear Trader.
Dang. There are a lot of Bear Traders. Okay, Marshall, you're going to send me the link, okay? Let's do it like that.
He can send you.
Send the link in the group chat here.
Yeah, exactly. The simple solutions are always the best. Why make yourself a lot more complicated? Alright, so everyone can find Bear Trader on Twitter, BEARTRADER. That's it. Where about else they can find you, Bear?
On Teta. And that's all.
That's it? That's where you know where to find me, marshalldraku.teta.tv. That's the main place where you can find the Posse channel, of course, and the Showdown podcast every Friday, same time. Grab us here. We're gonna upload that content on as many possible platforms as we can for everyone to grab up on what we were having some laugh. While we were ranting, chatting, and the info we provided that some of you may already hear, seen, or not. Thank you very much. That's it for us. Marshall Draco out. Good night, everyone. Hope to catch you next time. Yeah!